This time, we turn our attention to the 20-yard line on the home side of the field for the official welcome from PSJ Southwest Early College High School.
Good evening, Javelinas. Thank you all for joining us tonight. My name is Catherine De La Rosa, and I am this year's Student Council President. Our Student Council proudly serves as the District 16 Texas Association of Student Council Parliamentarian School. We would like to extend a warm welcome to the Sherryland Rattlers and thank them for joining us tonight. We hope for a fantastic game with amazing performances from the football teams, bands, dancers, and cheerleaders. With the guidance of our principal, Dr. Jose Montalongo, our administrators, teachers, and coaches, we have prepared for an amazing night full of fun, and we wish everyone a safe and fun time. Seniors, this is the last one, so let's make the best of it. And as always, go Javelinas, J's up.
At this time, we will have the response. Representing Sherryland High School will be Student Council Representative Ms. Ailani Suarez.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Andrea Ailani Suarez, Student Council Representative, and on behalf of the Sherryland High School student body, administration, and the Rattler community, we thank PSJA Southwest High School for your most cordial welcome to your home. Mike Marshall once said, "Victory is in the quality and competition and not the final score." May the athletes play this evening to the best of their abilities in the spirit of sportsmanship and athleticism. Thank you once again for your most sincere hospitality. We wish everyone tonight a safe journey home. Go Rattlers!
The officials for tonight's contest are brought to us by the Texas Association of Sports Officials Rio Grande Valley Chapter. They are the referee, Mr. Eric Clow. The umpire, Mr. Heriberto Samuel Cavazos. The head linesman is Mr. Joe Anthony Mendoza. The line judge, Mr. Eduardo Eloy Longoria, the back judge, Mr. Eddie Duran, the field judge, Mr. Jose Martinez, and the side judge, Mr. Jason Mendoza. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, if everyone would please rise as the state qualifying Sherryland Rattler Band will proudly perform their school's alma mater. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as our mighty Javelina Band will proudly perform our school's alma mater.
Thank you. that tireless and passionate effort.
Coaching, I think, is the most influential position in all of our schools.
A high school coach does more than just make someone excellent at their sport.
When somebody calls somebody a coach, I'd think of that, you know, right after mom and dad, it's coach.
The attitude, the care, the love that these coaches have for high school kids, you know, they're second to none.
He truly showed that he cared each day, and that's had a lasting impact on my life.
I just want all the coaches to know that we hold you in the highest esteem.
Coaches, you are the ones that set the culture in the building.
Showed me how to be tough, how to fight through adversity.
Once you get into high school, you spend more times with these coaches than you do your parents.
Someone who is a shepherd in your life, making a difference in your life.
He stepped into my life and was a father figure for me in so many ways.
Laying the foundation for the work ethic.
I personally want to say thank you to all of our high school coaches for molding our young children.
They're here because they want to do this for kids and see kids succeed.
Congratulations to all the high school coaches in Texas for the well-deserved recognition.
The 88th Legislature of the state of Texas hereby designates November 3rd as Texas High School Coaches Day.
And commends all those associated with the Texas High School Coaches Association for their dedicated efforts.
Thank you to all the Texas high school coaches for the positive impact you have on young people every day.
And thank you, Texas High School Coaches Association, for your continued mission on helping coaches help kids.
The state of Texas thanks coaches in every sport for their dedication to the mentorship of our youth.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're pleased to welcome you today to PSJ Stadium. Today we are celebrating the first ever Texas High School Coaches Day, and we want to take time tonight to recognize the dedication and support of our coaches. Billy Graham once said, "Coaches will impact more people in 1 year than the average person will in an entire lifetime." And that is why it is important to celebrate the contributions of our high school and middle school coaches across the state of Texas and right here at PSJ Southwest High School. Our coaches are full-time teachers, department chairs, hall and cafeteria monitors, disciplinarians, and grief counselors. They are field trip bus drivers, pep rally leaders, part-time field and faculty, maintenance workers, security guards, and janitors. They are the first to arrive on campus and the last to leave at night. But above all, they care for students and the community without expectation of praise and recognition. Coaches continually go above and beyond to serve students and communities. Tonight, we recognize our coaches for their passion and dedication to teaching and coaching and their positive impact on our students, athletes, and community. We also want to recognize the dedicated coaches at our PSJA ISD athletic departments, Kennedy Middle School, Escalante Middle School, and the staff from Sherryland High School. This is a day to celebrate their contributions as well. Please join me in giving these coaches a round of applause to show our support and appreciation. Thank you, coaches. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, everyone please rise for the presentation of colors and our national anthem. Presentation of colors will be performed by the PSJ Southwest JROTC Javelina Battalion Color Guard, commanded by Cadet Command Sergeant Major Alonso Villanueva, carrying the United States flag this evening. The Texas flag is being carried by Cadet Captain Jennifer Adame. The U.S. Guard is Cadet Corporal Jared Robledo, and the Texas Guard is Cadet Master Sergeant Visayda Ruiz. The color guard is under the direction of Senior Army Instructor Major James Kellum. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, for everyone, please rise and remove all head covering as we honor the greatest country in the world in the singing of her national anthem, tonight performed proudly by members of our PSJ Southwest Javelina Choir.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Welcome to beautiful PSA Stadium on the heart of the Rio Grande Valley. Tonight is the start of week 11 of high school football. My name is Pedro Leja. With me, my student reporter, Jorge Vadillo. Jorge, how are you?
Good. Very excited about tonight's game against Sherryland. The Javelinas are looking to close out the regular season with a victory.
Let's hope for the best. It's currently a beautiful 70 degrees here on the field. Let's take it upstairs. Javier Martinez and Jonathan Gonger are ready to bring us the action of the first half.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to PSJIC Football. That's right, folks. It's Thursday night, and the lights are shining bright here at PSJA Stadium, where KTRI will proudly bring you a District 16-5A Division II matchup between your very own PSJ Southwest Javelinas and the Sherryland High Rattlers. The Javelinas are led by their head coach, J.J. Leja, while the Rattlers are led by their head coach, Craig Snell. And of course, I'm Javi Martinez, bringing you the play-by-play action. Tonight, it's an honor, it's a treat. Welcome back, Isaac Serna, a blast from the past. And, you know, of course, we're going to have our stat man, Izzy Quintero. Isaac, hey. Chuck, welcome, buddy.
Hey, man, thank you for having me back. It feels great to be here, Javi. It reminds me of that old song with Peaches and Herb reunited, and it feels so good.
Absolutely,
just
without a doubt.
Just don't ask me to sing it.
So, Isaac, you know, welcome back. I know you've been busy with a lot of stuff. I know, you know, you're moonlighting here in the booth tonight, and I know on occasion you've been on the other side of this booth doing the public address announcement. So, you know, this falls right into your hands, man.
It does, man. It feels good. It's always nice to be around, but just to be around the football scene again.
There you go.
It's fantastic. It's fantastic weather that we have right now for a great football matchup, you know, between the PSJ Javelinas and the Sherryland Rattlers.
So it's an interesting matchup tonight. Of course, you know, it's a grand finale. We're at week 11. It's PSJ Southwest hosting Sherryland High, the Rattlers. Each team, though, has kind of struggled in district. You know, each team is 0-4. So tonight has a lot of standing, perhaps not in the overall standings, but I think you need to play well tonight in order to find something, you know, that silver lining, Chuck, to get yourself saying, you know, let's get motivated for the offseason.
Absolutely. And it's kind of like
turning our attention to the center of the
football brings out the competition in you. Mm-hmm. These guys are going to give it everything they have on both sides of the ball. So I'm pretty excited for the matchup that we're going to see here today.
Well, and I guess, you know, you can see on the field, we're about to do the coin flip. We got their four captains there for the Javelinas, and of course, three representatives from Sherryland High. And I think the other thing you see on the field is a great tribute is that, you know, you got your seniors lined up as well. And there you go. Great coverage right there by KTRI. And, you know, panning out on there, showing that love for the seniors. Because I tell you what, Chuck, you know, I played football. I'm not the biggest. I'm not the strongest. So I left it after my sophomore year. I was a baseball player, and I think I can compete in baseball. I can't do it 4 years of football. So I got to give a lot of credit to those young men that have endured 4 years of hard knocks.
you know, I'm right there with you, Javi. You know, I played 3 years there at PSJ North. Back in my day, I was a center, and back in my day, I was thought to be, you know, pretty good
guy.
Size. Yeah, but you know, there's no way I match up with these kids today. They're massive. They're out there, and they just. They're great to watch.
Yes, it is. It's a lot of fun. And, of course, you know, we're fortunate to be out here. It's final week of the regular season. Tomorrow we have a big one, you know, a little preview of tomorrow. So make sure you tune in tomorrow as well. It's going to be PSJ High hosting Edinburgh High, the Bobcats, the Bears versus the Bobcats for District 31-6A Championship. Of course, we're getting way ahead of ourselves. We're not even at the kickoff of this ball game yet. But still, tomorrow night it's a championship game. And early indications, Chuck, you know, they're talking about hopefully two playoff games being hosted here next week.
That
next
would be
Thursday,
amazing.
Possibly,
that would
be fantastic. And next Friday. So that'd be awesome.
It's something that would be great for the district. Just great to be around. It's going to be a great weekend of football all the way through, starting from today going into the weekend, you know, with college and NFL.
Yes, absolutely. And we're about set to get going here. The Javelinas are going to be receiving. The Rattlers are going to kick off. Defending the south end zone, and that's where the Javelinas are going to be headed, north to south, here after the opening kickoff. So sit back and relax, folks. We're about set to get the kickoff underway, and we're going to give you some football South Texas style, courtesy of PSJ ISD and KTRI. And there we go. Booming kick. It's going to be fielded about the 15-yard line by the Javelinas, trying to get upfield quickly, and the Javelinas do. So the Javelinas are going to have their first official play from the 27-yard line.
Let's welcome our anchor partners, Freedom Bank and Junior Supermarket, proud sponsors of PSJ Athletics.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Javelinas from their own 26-yard line officially, and let's see what the Javelinas can do last couple games. They've been struggling offensively. They just can't find the rhythm with their passing game, and that's hurt their running game. And on first down, they're going to try to run at the teeth of the defense. It's going to be about a yard gain, maybe two, up to the 28-yard line.
Yeah, nice little iso right up the gut by Jose Ibina right there. He did pick up about 2 yards, so it's looking good. Not too bad. You know, as long as you get positive yards, you're not playing behind the sticks, it's always going to be a good start.
Yeah, that's what I always say. If you can play in manageable situations, you're going to be good. But once, as you mentioned, once you're behind the sticks and you're a predominant running team, well, that's when you get in trouble. But on first down, a success of two yards, and I think we're going to see a lot of that this evening, a lot of ground and pound, and maybe mix it up a little. Of course, Logan Contreras, he's got a cannon of an arm, and we're going to see it here on second down. He's going to get flushed out of the pocket, looking. He's going to get knocked down in the backfield, couldn't get rid of it. That's going to be a quarterback sack all the way back to the 20-yard line. So a loss of 8. So as we mentioned, they're playing behind the sticks here on third down.
Yeah, now that's a big drop right there. But, you know, great job there by number 4, Santiago Longoria for the Rattlers.
And, of course, you got to add, you know, great coverage in the secondary. I think Contreras had a little bit of time, maybe not that great of time, but he could have unleashed that ball. Made a pass, but it said he gets sacked, so all the way back to the 20, so it's going to be third and 16.
Yeah, pretty sure Coach Leha doesn't really have a play in his book that's for this kind of situation, third and 16, but let's see what we got over here.
Well, look for Caleb Torres to be one of his favorite receivers. Quarterback rolls out, he's got some running room, fires, and he's simply going to throw it into the other team's bench. So a 3-and-out, not the start the Javelinas won it. They got 2 yards on first down, but bogged down after that, and I'm pretty sure we're going to see the punt unit come out now for the Javelinas.
Yeah, the Javelinas are definitely going to have to find a way to be able to stay balanced, right? They were able to get, you know, positive yards on first down. They went pass play second down, pass play third down, not too much success, so they're going to have to find a way to get that figured out for themselves.
But it'll be up to Aiden Vela to get a good boot here. He handles a bad snap. Good job. End over end punt. It's going to get past midfield. Check up. And the Javelinas are going to down it at the Rattlers' 47-yard line.
Thank you to our founding partners, Raising Cane's, and the City of Far.
Well, after a brief break, the Rattlers are going to take the field for the first time. Of course, their defense did the job. A 3-and-out. They gave up 2 yards on the run. Then A quarterback sack, an incomplete pass, a punt later, the Rattlers set up shop at their own 47-yard line, so just 3 yards shy of midfield, excellent field position. This is a good Rattler offense. They like to spread it out. As we see, the quarterback in shotgun formation. He's got three receivers to his right. It'll be a give. It's a good run. It'll be number 26 with the carry. Angel Ramirez, and Ramirez, I thought he had a lot more running room.
He certainly
did. He only
did.
Got two.
Yeah, the hole opened up, you know, fairly well. He's got to just be able to hit that to have more success there. But kudos to that Javelina defense for able to, you know, close their gap, squeeze in, and make a stop there. He only picked up 2 yards. And like you said, it looked like he was close to picking up at least 5-7 yards.
It looked like he had quite a bit of daylight. So good job, as you mentioned, by that Javelina defense closing in quickly. They're going to have to do it again. This time a jet sweep around the left side. They force the ball carrier in to the interior of that defensive line, nowhere to go, so no gain on the play, so it'll be third and long.
Yeah, there we see the on the Freedom Bank replay. They tried to get the sweep around, but Javelina sniffed it out from the get-go, and neighbor makes stop.
Replay by Freedom Bank.
So after a quick Freedom Bank replay, it's third down, and that's going to be intercepted. The Javelinas have a lot of running room in front of them, and they are off to the races, making headway, and the Javelinas do a great job. Adan Lopez, number 27, Johnny on the spot. They needed a big defensive play, and they got it from Lopez. The Javelinas have great field position after the first turnover of the ball game.
Great job by that defense. First play of the game, and it's first pass play of the game, and it's a turnover. Right here we see again on the Freedom Bank replay. They sniffed it out from the get-go. He had some great running room right there. Good block there. Mm-hmm. Almost jumped it, but then he decided to jump over him. But, hey, great spot here for the Javelinas, though. They're inside the 25-yard line.
Well, on first down, they're going to air it out. Little dump pass in the flat, and it is caught. Pushed forward, and the receiver, with a little help from the defense, gets up to about the 9-yard line. So, right there, Yair Amar, good reception, good run after the catch.
Yeah, it's a great play call, you know, and it's one of those situations where, you know, you do a little play action, and the quarterback doesn't have to do, you know, it's not one of those intermediate routes. It's a little bit
right.
Shorter, let your receiver do some work, and it's just to help build the confidence for your quarterback.
So, yeah, you're absolutely right. You know, that's an extension of the running play. You know, just roll out, hit your man when he's wide open, hit him in stride, and let him run with the ball after the reception. Great execution. That sets up a first and goal for the Javelinas. So Javelinas trying to strike first after forcing a turnover, a pass, and that's going to sail over everybody's head. And I tell you what, Chuck, I'm glad it sailed over everybody's heads because he threw into heavy coverage right there.
Yeah, I think it was one of those that he wanted that one back as soon as it left his hand. He just got to take his time, you know, stay in the pocket, stay under control. And we got a big second down here.
It'll be second and goal, and you're absolutely right. I think that's one where, you know, it's first and goal. Don't force the issue. You
right.
know, your defense has given you a golden opportunity. You cannot waste it. Javelinas back to the running game and just stuffed at the line of scrimmage. My goodness, two defenders for the Rattlers come up big in the backfield.
Yeah, they pushed them back pretty far. That puts them all the way back. It looks like the 13-yard line.
It will be the 13, so that'll be the second tackle for a loss for the Rattlers defense. They couldn't come at a bigger time. Third and very long. Third and goal from the 13-yard line. So it's anybody's guess what they're going to do here, but I anticipate a pass play right here. Let's see what Logan Contreras can do with his magical right arm. He's going to float it. It's going to be caught. A couple jukes, not much more than that. The ball carrier, after the reception, gets banged down. I believe that was Ibina with the reception. He gets back to the original line of scrimmage at the 9.
Yeah, he's back there at the 9. So right now the offense still holds up right here on 4th down. So we're going to find out. Looks like they're going to be going for it. And they're setting up for the field goal. I don't know, man. I'm kind of old school on that side. Hey, let's do it. Why not? We're 9 yards away.
It's the last game. What do you got to lose? You got nothing to lose, but it'll be a field goal attempt from 26 yards out. It's long enough, and I believe it's straight. And no, he misses it. He just pushed it off to the right. So a missed opportunity by the Javelinas. They come up empty. It'll be 0-0.
Thank you to our premier sponsors, La Quinta Inns and Suites FAR RGV Medical Center and FAR Crime Stoppers.
Well, you know, and it's a double whammy, I guess, if you will. You know, they missed the field goal. And then the ball gets spotted all the way to the 20-yard line. So the Rattlers are going to have the ball at the 20-yard line. They dodge a bullet. You know, we still have 7:29 remaining in the opening quarter, but it's been a good one. Rattlers with their second opportunity on their third play from scrimmage. They threw an interception. Let's see if they stick to the running game. No, they're going to air it out once again. Their quarterback has a lot of time, and he's going to just simply float it out of bounds. So smart decision by Bo Krell right there.
What a great name, right? Bo Krell.
Yes.
He was under pressure, though, so great job by the Javelina defensive line. They made him uncomfortable. They forced him out of the pocket, and he basically had to just get rid of that one as fast as he could.
And that's a smart football right there.
Right,
and,
absolutely.
Of course, I want to say, of course, their coach is Craig Krell. So I want to say this is probably his son playing quarterback. And, of course, if it's his son, he's got to be a very savvy quarterback. Probably knows the playbook in and out. And he's going to toss it. A good fake. A lot of blocking on the bubble screen on the outside. And the Rattlers, I believe, are going to have just enough yards for a first down. Yes, they do. They're going to push the receiver out of bounds at about the at the 34-yard line. So gain of 14.
Yeah, that's Mario Mendoza for the Rattlers. A little shifty there in those moves. He saw his blocks, was able to kind of maneuver around through them, and, you know, he picks up a first down for the Rattlers.
Well, that'll be the Rattlers' first down of the ball game. They're moving the chains. That stopped the clock at 7:15. Quarterback keeper, he floats it outside. Covered well. Can they make the tackle in the backfield? And he gets banged hard.
Oh, yeah, he's going to feel that one in the
morning
for sure.
Yes, that's one of those, you know, a whiplash hit right there. He got turned around. They got belted in the back. A loss of one, so great pass coverage right there by the Javelina defense.
Yeah, they almost had him for a big loss. Here we see it again on the Freedom Bank replay. Bo Krell gets rid of it, and right there he's got him turned around, but then he's, you know, the receiver's backpedaling. He's trying to get as much yards as he could, and wham, takes it right in the back.
that's going to stink. That might get some extracurricular activity coming out of the nose perhaps right there. So they're going to keep it on the ground, are the Rattlers. They're going to find a lot of running room. And after the race, Thiago Longoria gaps almost to your midfield. He's going to get past the first down marker and gets tackled at the 48-yard line. So 15-yard pickup.
Yeah, that's a big pickup there for the running back. I mean, he's the holes weren't as big as that he had on the drive before, but he was able to shift and maneuver and. That's a huge first down right there for the Rattlers.
Yeah, big chunk yard plays right there. So the Rattlers are moving the ball extremely well here on their second possession. Of course, their first possession ended with an interception. And on first down, Krell trying to find that slant right there. And perhaps the reason he couldn't connect with his receiver is going to be a hold on the defense or interference. And if it is, in either case, it'll be another first down for the Rattlers. And I'm sure they're going to cross midfield. We're going to wait the call here.
Pass interference. Defense, number 10. Spot foul, automatic, first down.
So it will be interference in fact, and that is definitely going to get the ball past midfield into Javelina territory. They're still waving. I don't know if it was that far into the secondary.
I didn't think it was either, but like you said, in either case, it's a first down. They're all the way inside their 38-yard line, it appears.
Well, a little bit generous perhaps on the spot, but in either case, it is a first down. They're going to air it out again on a high throw. Intended receiver could not grab it. Eduardo Mendoza was a target, clearly overthrown, so it'll be second down and 10 for the Rattlers from the Javelina's 38-yard line. Of course, this is the first time the Rattlers get into the Javelina's territory.
Yeah, the Javelinas are still looking good, though. You know, like we said, it's second and 10. You know, when you're second down, you can still kind of have to figure out if it's going to be a run, is it going to be a pass. But if they can get through second down right here, they'll be set up for a good third down. You want to set them up for a third and long.
Well, they're going to air it out once again. Krell looks. He's going to go deep. He's got a big arm, and he's going to throw it into the end zone, and it'll be incomplete just out of the outstretched hands of Bruno Cavazos. He had definitely beat the defender, but just couldn't come up with the reception.
Timeout for injury.
Well, folks, we're going to take an injury timeout with 5:42 remaining here in the opening quarter. It's been a good one. Right now, you know, PSJ Southwest 0, Sugarland High, the Rattlers 0. This is a final ball game of two teams who, you know, have struggled. They're going to try to get on the win column for the first time this evening.
Attention football fans and travelers. Experience the all-new La Quinta Inn & Suites RGV Medical Center. Newly remodeled rooms, top-notch amenities, and unbelievable hospitality. Book your stay now at La Quinta Inn & Suites RGV Medical Center, located at 4603 North Cage Boulevard in Far, where comfort meets luxury.
Well, after a brief commercial break, Isaac, you know, it's a well-played ball game. You know, unfortunately, right now they're tending to a player that it's hurt, but that's just part of the ball game. It's, you know, it's a hard-hitting affair. And right now we're in a scoreless tie. And, you know, what are your initial thoughts?
You know, both defenses are playing well. I'm excited to see this third and long situation for the Javelinas. If they can get past this one, they're going to be in a great spot. I don't anticipate them trying to go for it on fourth and long. You know, if they do punt, you know, they could get, you know, deep in their own field position.
Yes.
But I am thinking ahead, so they do got to get through this third down. That second down previous play, it was a break for the Rattlers, but, you know, a helpful one for the Javelinas. That one was a pretty good throw by the quarterback. Just, you know, fell through the receiver's hands.
Yeah, it was a good route, good pass, just an incompletion. And, well, the Rattlers may get a free play here. They're going to let a play on. Krell waving everybody, just go deep. I'll throw it, and he finally does. Throws a bullet, and what a great reception right there by number 9. And before he gets out of bounds, that's Eduardo Mendoza catching it about 3 to 4 yards shy of the first down, but of course, there is a penalty flag.
Yeah, it's a great heads-up play by the quarterback. He knew he got an offsides.
Offsides, defense, number 74. 5-yard penalty, replay, third down.
And of course, the Rattlers are going to take the 5-yard penalty instead of about a 7-yard pickup on the pass play, because if they don't,
then
it would
fourth,
be fourth
yeah.
and three. And that's wisely. It's going to be 3rd and 5. So now they got 2 opportunities to pick up 5 yards. So the ball gets pushed up to the 33-yard line. Shotgun formation. Quarterback airs it out. And again, a nice little route. But the just too much air under it. It gets sails over the intended receiver's hands. Incomplete. So now it'll be 4th and 5.
Yeah, now 4th and 5. It's a little bit of a different situation, right? We're inside the 35-yard line. 4th and 5. It's very, very manageable. But great job by the defender there, number 4, Jaden Mejia.
So the Rattlers are going to go for it. It would be more or less like a 51-yard field goal attempt. So that's rare to be made by a high school kicker. The Rattlers are going to air it out once again, looking over the top. A man's wide open. And again, just Krell, maybe he's just too hyped up, too pumped
little,
up.
A little too much mustard on that one,
yes,
yeah.
Yes, he had 2 receivers open on this drive in the end zone, could not connect. So the Javelinas will take over on downs.
Yeah, he had his running back, Santiago Longoria, running right up the seam in between the two defenders. He got past them both, but a little too much on that pass. And luckily for the Javelinas, they get to take over. And they're not in too bad field position, right? They're starting at their own 33-yard line.
Yeah, not bad at all. And let's see what the Javelinas can do. And on first down, they're going to test the heart of that defense and maybe getting tripped up, maybe a yard, maybe 2. It all depends. And I believe they're going to get up to the 34 from the 33. So to get 1 yard, not much more than that.
Yeah, not a whole lot there. But I looked like he had a little more than that, but I guess maybe his knee hit previously to where I thought he went.
Yeah, but I like what they're doing, though. I think early on in the ballgame, you got to test that defensive line. And let's see if your offensive line can win some battles and open up some holes and get some good yards rushing, but instead the Javelinas are going to air it out, and that is caught. A good reception right there by Caleb Torres, I believe. So that'll move the chains. So Logan Contreras connects with Torres.
Yeah, it was a great route. It was kind of like a little bench route. He was coming across from the other side of the field. Great play there, and it's kind of like you said, you know, right now the Sherryland Rattlers have been running basically with a 3-down lineman.
Mm-hmm.
It's and like I said earlier, right, I'm a ground-and-pound kind of guy, so I would like to see the Javelinas kind of take advantage of that situation. You see the big old gaps.
Yeah, they're almost forcing you, but then again, with 3-down linemen, my goodness, I believe that is big old number 99, Thomas Sauceda. He just gets in there like a madman and causes havoc, a tackle for a loss all the way back to the Javelinas' 46-yard line.
Yeah, the Rattlers looking good there with a nice little run blitz. The lineman kind of had to pick up either the backer or the defender. that case, he picked up the linebacker, and so we had a free rein right there to the running back.
And it's interesting, Chuck, you mentioned that. You know, you got five down linemen. You got three defensive men. You got to pick somebody.
Right.
Pick your poison, and that time, again, they're going with a run blitz, and it's aired out. Yahid Ahmad was the intended receiver, just slips off his fingertips. That would have been a good gain if he comes up with the reception. Pass was a little bit too tall, though, so it'll be third and long.
Yeah, they got to get all the way down to the 41-yard line for a first down here. It's going to be tough. It's, you know, it's like we said earlier, there's not a whole lot of plays in your playbook for third and 12-plus.
Yeah, that's the thing, as we've noticed so far this evening. Every time Logan Contreras has passed the ball, he's 3 for 5 for 31 yards. But they're short passes. They're short passes. And, of course, now we got Marquez Luengo at quarterback. So let's see what Luengo can do. But before
timeout.
We're going to
have
PJ
Southwest.
A PJ
first timeout
Southwest
or the first half?
Timeout.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
But, of course, we're back to live action. We got exactly 4 minutes remaining here in the opening quarter here at beautiful PSJA Stadium. Proud production of KTRI. Of course, I'm Javi Martinez. Isaac Serna here with me tonight. It's a beautiful evening for football. And, you know, both teams, I think they're well represented out here. Both the Javelina fans and the Rattler fans are out here enjoying this ball game here on a beautiful Thursday evening.
Yeah, great weather, great views. It's a great day for some football. And like you said, we still have some great games tomorrow as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a lot at stake tomorrow. You know, in District 32-6A, I believe San Benito and Westlake are playing for a district title. As we mentioned earlier, in District 31-6A, PSJ High battles Edinburgh High. And in District 16-5A, Division 2, which is this district that we're seeing here tonight, it's Roma can win the district championship if they beat Mission Vets. If Mission Vets wins and Sherland Pioneer win, then it would be a three-way tie for first. So I'm not sure how. I guess they're going to go to point differential to see who the actual winner is. And a bubble screen just absolutely goes nowhere. The Javelinas are actually going to lose quite a bit of yards right there. So they're going to get backed up all the way to their own 41-yard line. So they had the ball 1 yard shy of midfield. But now they're backed up. It's going to be fourth, and I'm sure the punt unit team will take the field once again for the Javelinas.
Yeah, we see Adam Vela back there. Looks like he's going to get ready to do his thing also. But, you know, like we were saying earlier, both defenses have been playing very well for the Rattlers and the Javelinas. Hopefully the Javelinas got another one in them right here, and they can get a stop on this drive.
A rugby-style punt. It's a booming punt. Fielded at about the 26-yard line. That is Jorge Briones. Briones still on his feet, juking and jiving. And a lot of dancing, but not a lot of yards. But still, the Rattlers are going to have good, solid field position in a scoreless tie at their own 31-yard line.
Yeah, he was looking like that human joystick for a little bit, really shifty.
Absolutely.
First down now for these guys. I hope these, you know, we've seen Sherryland kind of sticking more to their passing game.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see if they've made any type of adjustments. You know, Bo Krill has been making some great passes. They did follow up short, so here we have a nice little run up the middle. He gets a nice chunk of change on that one. I think he gets almost six yards there. That was tough running there, Santiago Longoria.
Yep, good run right there by... Well, I
timeout
think we're going to have an
injury
timeout. And we'll have that with 2:46 remaining in the first quarter. And, of course, a scoreless tie here at beautiful PSJA Stadium. And, you know, right now it's interesting to where neither team is really able to advance the ball on the opposition. And, you know, That's a key why we have a 0-0 score. I think both teams have had golden opportunities. Javelinas had first and goal. The Rattlers had two passes that could have been potential touchdown in the end zone, but yet we're scoreless.
Yeah, so the Rattlers are looking at a second down here. And like you said, they did have a good shot over here. They were across midfield into Javelina territory, but they weren't able to capitalize in that. Neither were the Javelinas when they had that interception. They were looking at a first and goal. But, I mean, it's one of those situations where you like to see those defensive games.
Right. I love defensive struggles. I really do. Don't get me wrong. I also like scoring if they're well played. Right. I just don't like, you know, okay, here's a pass and nobody can make a tackle, touchdown. Here's a run. It's a gaping hole. Nobody was there to stop them. It's a touchdown. You know, that kind of, it's fun, you know, and you see them running. You see the athleticism. But I also like to see these big bad boys on the defensive line, the hard-hitting linebackers, the secondary coming up, cleaning up a tackle. That's football to me.
Old school style.
Yes, that's what I grew up with, you know. No blood, no foul. That's basically what I love right there. Of course, that, you know, now it's more precautious, and, of course, the safety of the kids is, of course, the utmost importance. But still, I like kids getting hit, knocked down every once in a while.
And I'm sure they love doing it, too.
So the player is going to be all right. He's going to come back in the ball game as he walks off on his own 2 feet. But before we have the next play, we're going to have a false start on the Rattler. So that'll back him up.
Illegal snap. Offense, number 60. 5 yards, still second down.
I like the way they name it, like illegal snap.
Yes.
Right? It's just one of those, his hand probably just twitched.
Yeah.
And the ball moved.
Well, we're going to have the Rattlers now a 2nd and 9. And you know, right now, Bo Krell, 2 of 8 passing for just 13 yards, but he's got a tremendous arm. He's got fast receivers. He just hasn't been in sync with them. Here's a little shovel pass, and it'll be Santiago Longoria. He's going to get bottled up right at the 35-yard line. So, again, great job by the defense recognizing the play and making a tackle.
Yeah, I think that was Edward Montañez making the play there. And just kind of like you said, Bo Krell's kind of having to kind of move maneuver out of the pocket. Nice little shovel pass. But Montañez had that read the whole way, and he waited for the rest of his troops to get there and help him out. Great job by the defense.
Excellent open field tackle.
See, now the Rattlers are in the situation that we're talking about, right? Now they're back in 3rd and long. Let's see how the Javelina defense responds to that.
Well, we got a man in motion. They're going to go the other way. A nice screen. He's got a lot of running room. Definitely pick up more than enough for a first down. Stays on his feet. Bulldozes over somebody. That's a mad runner right there, Santiago Longoria. He bullies his way all close to midfield. They're going to officially say he stepped out of bounds at the 48-yard line. That's a big 13-yard pickup on 3rd down for the Rattlers.
I mean, you said the best, Javi, a big-time play on that 3rd down. He basically one-handed that catch.
Yeah.
And just followed his blockers and was able to pick up a 1st down, running somebody over on his way to it.
Yes, he did. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's football right there.
He
that's
heard
hard
you.
Hitting.
He heard
Aaron,
you.
Hard hitting.
Oh,
the quarterback gets walloped. And there's a pass, though. It does not matter. Santiago Longoria sneaks out of the backfield. He's going to sneak it to the end zone. Quarterback paid the price, but he has the last lap as the Rattlers strike first with a 52-yard touchdown pass.
Yeah, Santiago Longoria was pretty much uncovered on that play. And it's kind of like you said, his athleticism took it all the way for the touchdown, and man, did Bo Krell take a hit on that pass. But it's kind of like you said, well worth it for him because, hey, his Rattlers are up 6 right now, and they're going for 2, it looks like, possibly.
Yeah, I think so. Well, they got the quarterback out there, and they got Longoria out there right next to him, so they will be going for 2.
Yeah.
And Longoria, it's just basically Longoria, you can try to get it, and he is not going to be able to do that great job defensively on the 2-point conversion. So, folks, with a 1:22 remaining here in the opening quarter, well, hold the phones. We have a penalty.
Illegal formation on the kicking team. The penalty's declined. The extra point is no good.
Well, there you go. They're going to pick up the flag. So with 1:22 remaining here in the opening quarter, it's Sherryland High 6, PSG Southwest 0.
Yeah, Sherryland came out lining up kind of fancy. Mm-hmm. So it was one of basically those trick formations.
Right.
They might not have had enough people on the line of scrimmage. You got to have at least 7 people on the line of scrimmage. So if it's in the legal formation, that's probably going to be my best bet as to what happened. A little too much trickery.
Yeah.
Might have outsmarted themselves on that one, though.
Exactly. Well, you know, the Rattlers right now, they have a 6-0 lead. They've accumulated already 117 total yards, while the Javelinas, they had great opportunity on their second possession, but were not able to convert. They only have 14 total yards, but they only find themselves trailing by 6 with 1:22 remaining here in the first quarter. And again, the Javelinas will be receiving for the 2nd time in this ball game. And well, that took the Rattlers a minute 39 on fourth place from 52 yards out. So number 22, AJ Arevalo. Arevalo with the return back to the 30-yard line for the Javalinas. So that's where they're going to take over. This time trailing by six.
Yeah, you said it only took them about a minute and 39 seconds. They did have those back-to-back big-time plays on third down. And, of course, the next play where Longoria was able to take that touchdown pass into the end zone.
Well, the quarterback drops back. There's a penalty flag, and the pass is incomplete into the Javelinas bench. And usually when it's a penalty in the backfield, it's going to be a hold. Well, let's see if the Rattlers elect to take the penalty or decline it after an incomplete pass.
Yeah, he's asking the coach over there what he's going to want to do. It kind of looked like a busted play from the get-go.
Mm-hmm.
Holding, offense, number 64. 10 yards, replay, first down.
You know, not to say that it wasn't a play-action pass, but, you know, the Luengo's going one way and his quarterback went the opposite way.
Yeah, something was definitely off on that play, and Marcus Luengo just had nothing to do but throw it, and, of course, you know, it doesn't matter because there was a hold, so it'll be first and 20. It'll be a give up the middle. A lot of running room, and off to the races are the Javalinas. Of course, that was Jose Ipina getting the penalty yards back, plus about three or four up to the 34-yard line.
Yeah, that was a great run there by Ipina, just right up the gut. Great blocking by up front by those big hogs.
Well, Ipina picked up 14 yards, and after four attempts, he's got exactly 14 yards because he's been tackled for a loss a couple times.
But the best part, Javi, it's second and manageable, right?
Yes.
They were first in a mile,
mm-hmm.
and now they're second down, and they're not behind the stick, so it's good right there. Second and six.
Shotgun formation in the pistol. They're going to give it off to Ipina. Once again, he fights off a couple would-be tacklers. Gains a couple. Hard-fought 2 yards right there, up to the 36-yard line. So, again, as you mentioned, you know, it's a manageable third down. It's third and six. It's Well, 34 actually now. But still, you can run, you can pass. You're not one-dimensional, and you never know what can happen. But before we see that third and six.
Into the first quarter.
The first quarter comes to a conclusion here from beautiful PSJA Stadium. It's the Rattlers 6, the Javalinas 0.
The bonds we create with our pets can be powerful. A man's best friend really isn't just about dogs, but about any animal companion that brings us joy and unconditional love. Losing a loved one is heart-wrenching, but losing a pet can be just as difficult. Unconditional love deserves unmatched service, which is why we offer pet services for those special pets that become a special part of the family. We serve all the members of your family.
Well, the Javalinas are going to go for it on third down, trying to pick up the first down yardage. Getting bumped is a quarterback out of bounds after about a 2-yard pickup up to the 38. Of course, the first down marker sits at the 40-yard line. So, interesting call for Coach Leija. It's going to be fourth and two.
Yeah, fourth down. Would you call that a long two or a short two? There's a difference.
I want to say it's a long two because the punt unit's going to come out.
Yeah. Yeah, Coach Leija's not going to take any chances. He wants to get he's going to go ahead and bring his punting unit out here. No, they're still out there. Okay.
Yeah, so Aiden Vela is going to punt once again. A good, solid punter for the Javalinas. The deep men for the Rattlers are sitting around their own 30-yard line. A good, high, hanging punt. Defense, well, they're going to call a fair catch. So that's how good of a punt that was. So the Rattlers will take over at their own 26-yard line.
Champions don't settle for less. Knock out injuries with UT Health RGV Sports Medicine, the official sports medicine doctor for the UT RGV Vaqueros and PSJA ISD. UT Health RGV, keeping Vaqueros and you in the game.
Well, here we go, folks. The Rattlers, once again, with the ball, with a 6-0 lead this time from their own 26-yard line. Bo Crowell with 80 yards passing. The Rattlers with just 37 yards rushing. They're going to add to that passing total, and then we're going to have a penalty flag. So initially, it's about an 8 to 9 yard pickup, but of course, we're going to have to wait and see what the penalty flag is all about. If it's on the offense, it's coming back. If it's on the defense, it'll probably hold.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense, number 78. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Our Pack the House schools this evening, they are Garcia Elementary, Aida Escobar Elementary, Geraldine Palmer Elementary, and Kelly Farr Elementary. Thank you for coming out and supporting your PSJ Southwest Javelinas.
And, of course, we thank the future Javelinas to be out here, all these elementaries out here supporting the Javelina Nation this evening with Pack the House. And with that being said, the Rattlers do some damage of their own. A great pass by Krill, a great completion. The Rattlers cross midfield. They're at the Javelinas 48-yard line.
Yeah, that was a big-time throw by Bo Krill there, hitting the receiver. That was Eduardo Mendoza. I'll tell you what else he did that was great, Javi. The defender was on him. He was there, right? But he waited to the last second to get his hands up to catch that ball so that the defender couldn't even get a chance to turn around and try to play it.
Right, he kind of deked him right there, and the defender never knew where the ball was. The reception was made, and testing the run defense are the Rattlers, and the Rattlers are going to pick up 1 yard, not much more than that. So the Javelina defense surely has done the job against the run. They just got to shore up their pass defense.
Replay by Junior Supermarket.
Well, after a Junior Supermarket replay, it'll be 2nd and 9. The Javelina defense trying to get a defensive stop as they trail by 6. And on 2nd down, the Rattlers are going to fight forward. It's a good reception. That'll net about 5 or 6 yards of tackle made at the 42-yard line. So pick up a 5. 3rd and very manageable upcoming for the Sherryland offense.
Yeah, that was great communication, right, between Bo Krill and his receiver, Calvin Harris, right? Harris realized that the coverage on him was pushed back rather far, so he shortened his route, and Krill was able to hit him for a quick 5 yards there. That was a good play by those two.
Yeah, underneath route right there, and that's the thing. The Javelinas are respecting the deep ball because Krill's got a heck of an arm. They've gone deep a couple times, and underneath, and maybe a hold, and yes, it is. It's going to be a hold or an interference. In either case, it'll be a result of another Sherryland first down. And that's one of those that, you know what, it's
sometimes
okay to hold
choice,
him
yeah.
Because if he makes a catch in stride, he may still be running towards the end zone right now.
Absolutely. I was thinking the same thing. I was thinking, you know what, that's a good flag. I'll take that.
Pass interference. Defense. Or the ball will be placed in the spot of the foul. Automatic. First down.
Well, indeed, it'll be interference. It'll be at the spot, and they're going to spot it at the 36-yard line. So that'll be a first down via penalty. But nonetheless, it is a first down, and the Rattlers are going to have a new set of downs. They're going to keep this drive alive. Trying to extend this 6-0 lead, and wow, that's the arm strength. I mean, he's sitting almost down. Obviously, he can't be sitting down because that would have been a dead play, but he's falling backwards and still slung it about, what, 10, 15 yards on a rope.
Yeah, that was just a great play, man. Talk about awareness and just the athleticism to be able to get that throw off. Very impressive. But great job by the Javelina defense. Mm-hmm. They were right there. They made the play. It was only a gain of 1 when it could have been more.
There's a replay. That's just a frozen rope and an even better open field tackle right there by number 10 for the Javelinas. Diego Lopez saving the day, only giving up 1 yard on that reception. Krill throws. This time it'll be incomplete. So 3rd and long. So this is exactly what the Javelina defense needs to do. put the Rattlers on third and long and get themselves an opportunity to get the ball back.
Right, third and long, so they got to get at least, it's 9 yards for the first down. Mm-hmm. You basically are already knowing, you know, what to expect.
Right.
Not necessarily the exact player, what's going to happen, but you kind of know defensively what you have to work with. We can not necessarily ease up a little bit, but now these little five-yard routes are not going to be as effective for
and
them.
And this is one of those where, you know what, I like to live dangerous. Let's get a blitz going here. Let's put pressure on that quarterback. Let's get him a little bit unsettled in the pocket. Maybe an errant throw. Well, it's going to be a bad snap. The quarterback keeps it, and he's going to do everything he can. And in either case, you know, he did the right job of throwing it out of bounds, so that sets up a fourth down. Didn't panic. So it'll be fourth from the 35, and now do the Rattlers go for it? You know, you got a 6-0 lead, 9:09 before the half.
Well, they're contemplating it, that's for sure. It's fourth and long.
Yeah, you're kind of middle of nowhere, you know. I think too far for a field goal. Too short, really. If you punt it, you only gain about 10, 15 yards. So you might as well go for it, and they are going to go for it. Empty backfield for Bo Krell. Three receivers to his left, two to his right. Pick your poison. Krell's going to go over the top. He's got a man streaking, and again, just overshoots a wide-open receiver. Calvin Harris clearly wide open. Krell overthrows him. So the Javelinas, once again, they dodge that bullet, and they're going to take over at their own 35-yard line.
Order like a champ at Raising Cane's. We've got tailgates of hand-battered, cooked-to-order chicken fingers and cane sauce, and jugs of freshly made tea and lemonade. Touchdown! Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
So on first down, a bad snap. Pina grabs it, almost bobbles it again, but still fights forward, gets past the 40, up to the 41-yard line. Good 6-yard pickup. And then at the end, we got a flag. So let's see what happened there. Is it perhaps a hold, perhaps a face mask? I didn't see much.
It was definitely one of those after the play, so it's likely to be an unsportsmanlike.
Well, they're talking about it. So if it is a dead ball foul, the play will count as a 6-yard pickup. Now it all depends on what the infraction actually is.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, offense, number 8, 15-yard penalty, and number 8 is disqualified.
Oh, wow. So not sure.
Yeah, even Logan Contreras is a bit confused on that one. You know, the quarterback, he's saying, well, what happened? Pina picked up 6 yards. I didn't see anything, Isaac, you know, to be honest with you. Maybe, and again, we don't know what words are exchanged down there. So he may have said a no-no that agitated the official, and that's an ejection. And I tell you what, Pina is a huge loss.
Yeah, so it's it looked like he kicked his foot or they twisted his ankle or something, and they might have, you know, maybe it triggered him into something. But in either case, you got to be able to stay calm
exactly.
in a situation like that. You got to know that your team needs you.
Well, that's a big time loss. And after that penalty, though, the Javelinas air it out. They're going to get a lot of those penalty yards back. They're going to be at the 39-yard line. So, you know, in all essence, they lost 2 yards, but more importantly, they lost a key player. And, you know, that's very unfortunate, especially here on the final weekend of the football season. But you move on. You move on, and you play the game, and on third down, Javelinas is going to air it out. The reception made by Kyler Abrego, and Abrego is going to get belted, and he's going to get tackled about 3 yards shy of the first down at the 42, so gain of 3, but they're going to need 3 more for the first down.
Yeah, the punting unit's coming back out. But it was a nice little wide receiver screen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, unfortunately, he was a few yards short, so now they're looking at fourth down. And like you said, Javi, I'm still a little shocked, right, because the Javelinas are going to have to figure out a way to get their offense going, right? Pina was a big part of that.
Yes. Well, it's a big loss, like I said, but, you know, it's football. Sometimes you lose them to injuries. Sometimes you lose them to penalties. And the punt is made by the Javelinas. The Return man's going to look to return it this time at the 22. He's got a lot of running room on the far sideline, but finally gets dragged out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. So that's where the Rattlers will take over on their next possession.
Kids can be anything they desire. This is why school plays an important role that shapes their lives. Every day counts to make an impact in your child's life. My opportunities start at PSJA ISD.
Well, welcome back, folks. We have 7 minutes and 14 seconds before the half. It's an interesting game. You know, stat-wise, the Rattlers have 162 yards. The Javelinas only 57. But on the scoreboard, that's the most important thing. It's a one-possession game. Sherland leads 6-0. Carell looks. He throws. Oh, almost a great catch. And unfortunately, we're going to have another penalty flag. And I'm impressed with Crow's arm. You know, he just stood there and just flicked it out there, slung it out there for about 30 yards.
Yeah, he definitely threw the ball where it needed to be to his receiver. It's almost going to be like if they're going to call, let's see right here, it's going to be some type of interference. Maybe it's face guarding.
There are 2 fouls on the play. Ineligible man downfield, offense, number 78, pass interference, number 4. Let's play with Klein, replay first down.
Well, I think he means the offset.
Yes, the offset is the key word there. We're all under pressure. You know, the kids are playing under pressure. The officials are under pressure. And, of course, we're human beings, and we all make mistakes. So it'll be offsetting, so it's like nothing ever happened. So it'll be first down once again from the Sherryland Rattler 38-yard line.
You know, you brought up how the Rattlers already have 162 yards. Mm-hmm. It just kind of shows that the Javelina defense, though, has been coming.
Again, you know, Crail just overshooting his receivers. I tell you what, if he's 50% just more accurate, I think the score is a lot different than 6-0.
You know, he seems to be having more success on the intermediate to deeper routes.
Yes.
Than those shorter ones. Maybe he's putting a little bit too much, you know, on them. He's going to break one of these guys' fingers.
Yeah, he's putting a little bit too much juice on that ball, and you're absolutely right. And here we may see that a little bit underneath route. And Grell, under pressure, he's going to scramble. He's got a lot of running room. He's going to pick up at least, well, actually, he's going to pick up a first down for the Rattlers. He needed 10. He picked up exactly 10 from the 38 to the 48. So that'll be another Rattler first down. Good job by Grell on the scramble drill there. And, you know, the Rattlers on the evening only have 48 yards rushing, but they have 124 yards passing.
Yeah, they're even though the yards don't necessarily reflect it, they are finding balance
right, as far
as you know how the game is being called offensively for them.
Well, they've passed the ball 19 times. They've only ran it 8. So Crowell's gonna get his 20th pass attempt, possibly. No, he's not. He's gonna tuck in. He's gonna run. He's gonna scramble past midfield up to the Javelinas 48-yard line. So gain of 4, 2nd and 6 upcoming for the Rattlers. Of course, the clock stops as he goes out of bounds with 6.5 minutes remaining in the second quarter.
Yeah, right at midfield, Rattlers are looking like they're going to continue to move.
3-down lineman for Javelinas trying to stop this drive. A rare run, and it's a good one. And, well, there maybe that's why it's a good one, because we're going to have a penalty flag thrown. About 10, 12 yards picked up right there by number 18, Sebastian Martinez.
Holding. Offense, number 78. 10 yards, 2nd down.
But, of course, Martinez's run will be for naught, as this one's going to come back due to holding. And, again, that's probably what sprung him.
Yeah, I mean, it was almost easy for us to see that the flag was thrown right before he even crossed the line of scrimmage. The flag even landed at the line of scrimmage.
So they're going to back him up to the 42-yard line.
Yeah, Javelin's got to take advantage of the situation, right? It's 2nd and a mile for the Rattlers. So if they can keep them behind the sticks, it's going to be a good situation for them.
So 2nd down. you know, for a spread offense, they like to take their time, do the rattlers. They're not a hurry-up offense.
No, I think they definitely want to see what the defense is going to give them, and then they try to get their play in.
Absolutely right, and there's a completion. It's Mario Mendoza, and Mendoza's going to get past midfield. It's going to be about third and six upcoming.
Yeah, it's going to be another big down for the Javelina defense. We're going to see if they're going to be able to hold them one more time. You know, you really don't want to see the Rattlers kind of get any positive yardage because I think we're going to be in a situation where they're going to want to go for it again on fourth down with 6 minutes left.
Third and six. Grell asking for the snap. They're going to come after him. He's going to loft it. He's got a man streaking down the sideline, but he's going to sail that out of bounds. Great coverage right there. And I think both players may be a bit banged up. That was Jaime Contreras with the coverage. And, of course, the intended receiver was Eduardo Mendoza. So it'll be fourth down. And I believe the Rattlers are going to send their punt unit team onto the field. So, once again, Isaac, you're absolutely right. The Javelinas did give up some yards. They gave up a first down, but then they forced a punt. A lot of late substitutions for the Javelinas here. A crazy formation on this punt. I'm not sure what's going to happen here. Are they going to fake it? Heavy rush. They bump into the punter, but no penalty. The run back from the Javelinas from the 20 up to the 24. So the Javelinas will take over at their own 24-yard line with 5:38 remaining in the second quarter. They throw by six. And, well, folks, we're going to send it down to our student reporters for the first time this evening.
Hi, my name is George Badillo, and I'm a KTR student reporter, and I'm here with Andra Barbosa, the Escobar Cheer Elementary coach. Ms. Barbosa, what can you tell us about the Escobar Cheer program?
Hi, so the Escobar Cheer program, originally we didn't have a cheerleading squad. So this being our second year, in the first year, we thought what better way to have a cheerleading squad and put it together. So with it being our second year, the first year we took them to perform at the RGV Vipers game, the RGV Toro soccer game. Not only do we perform with our community, but we also took our girls to the Spurs versus Lakers basketball team, and this will be our second year taking the girls that way. So it's an experience for our squad and our school.
Thank you so much for your time. Back to you guys upstairs.
Wow, very impressive there, Isaac. I want to join that cheer squad right there. I want to go to the Spurs basketball game to watch against the Lakers. My goodness, sign me up as a male chaperone.
Get to watch Victor Wembanyama and LeBron James.
Yeah, so that's awesome. And I like, you know, the fact that they venture out. You know, they do that, exposing their kids, and it's a great cheer program. No doubt about that. They're happy, and there you go. You see them cheering. Great coverage by KTRI, as always. Gotta love that. Future of Javelinas in the making right there. And right now, the Javelinas got to get something going offensively. It is third down and 10 quickly from the 24-yard line.
Yeah, first down, they went for a run up the middle. Didn't have much success. It looks like we have an end-around reverse over here.
And it's a successful one. Very close to the first down. Well, it all depends on the spot, and I think they're going to give them the spot. You had to get to the 34, and I believe that's exactly where they're going to spot it. That should be a first down, and it will be. So move the chains for the Javelinas, a new set of downs. There we see on the juniors replay. Good piece of running by Ozzy Espinosa on the reverse, on the end around right there.
Yeah, you could tell how hard he was running. Like, he definitely wanted to make sure that he was going to make that play.
And again, you know, with Abini out of the game, this is the opportunity for some of these other running backs to shine. And right there, great example, Ozzy coming through. Contreras back at quarterback. He's going to fire, and the completion will be made, but the catch by Salas will be out of bounds. And, you know, I don't know if you watched last week's game and the week prior to that for the Javelinas, but that's what we saw a lot of. They run a lot of routes near the sideline, and unfortunately, it's too deep into the sideline. It does not give the receiver an opportunity to make a reception in the field of play. As a result, it's incomplete.
And to be honest with you, Javi, on that play, I don't even know that Contreras really wanted to go that route. It looked like he wanted to hit the running back out of the flat, but he got chipped by the defender.
Okay.
Pretty much put him on his back, which is perfectly legal. Of course, he was behind the line of scrimmage still. Oh, no!
And he trips over his own running back, and that'll be a quarterback, a team quarterback sack, if you will. And that's going to push back the Javelinas back to their own 28-yard line. So that's a tough break right there. That's an absolutely heartbreaker for the Javelinas offensively.
Yeah, you see right there, it's just incidental contact between the two players, and it kind of just trips up the quarterback, Logan Contreras. And now they're in a situation that they don't want to be in, right? It says third down, but I think that's barely second down.
Yeah, this will be third down. It'll be third down. And
so now it's third and long. And we've been saying it all night, you know, you don't really have a play to be able to convert, so you kind of have to hope for the best.
Well, they're playing behind the chains. You don't want to do that, and they're coming after him. A good screen, though, a lot of running room, and the Javelinas get bottled up. My goodness, I thought that was going to be very close to a first down and set the Rattlers defense. They do their job. They get to the ball carrier, the receiver, very quickly, make the tackle at the 35, only a gain of 7. Wow. Great job right there.
Timeout. Sherry High.
Yeah,
first timeout of the first half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Do you need fast, affordable internet? The City of FAR will be providing high-speed internet starting as low as $25 a month. And for PSJ households, you will receive free internet. Call 956-402-2000 for more information.
Well, folks, after the timeout, you know, Southwest has two timeouts. Sherland High has two timeouts. We got 2:53 remaining before the half. And it's going to get interesting here. It's fourth down. And the Javelinas are going to punt. So Sherryland, of course, they can double dip here. You know, they're going to get the ball here on this punt, unless there's a fake. But I'm pretty sure they're going to punt. And to start the second half, Sherryland will get the ball. So this is an opportunity for Sherryland to really pick up the pace and extend their lead. Right now it's just 6-0. Takes a great roll, but it's going to get picked up. And Marcos Esparza is going to traverse from one sideline to the other. Ran about 60, gained about 2.
There you go. I was about to say, it only counts for 2, though. I mean, he's going to be gassed. He ran all the way from sideline to the other sideline. But, you know, kind of to bring back what you're talking about, Javi, it's you know, it's still only 6-0. I think right now Coach Leja's trusting his defense, mm-hmm. right, to continue to play well.
Definitely.
The touchdown that they had was on a
– illegal formation on the kicking team. 5-yard penalty, replay, fourth down.
Well.
Another punt.
Yeah, and I think that is absolutely the correct call. You know, you just had your punt unit run down the field 40 yards and then run across the field 50
right.
yards, and they're gassed. So now, you know what? Make them punt it again. And Sherryland, I'm predicting it. They're going to get a tremendous return here unless – you know, number 11, Mr. Vela, Aiden Vela, makes a very good punt, a very time-consuming hanging punt here.
Yeah, you definitely want this punt it's going to be difficult, right? But we want it to get across midfield. You definitely don't want the Rattlers to be able inside your own field position already with 2.5 minutes left.
It's a low punt, but a good boot.
It's a good one.
Fielded at the 40, and a fair catch. Well, that's disappointing to me. I wanted to see a run back. But in either case, you know, of course, we're rooting for the Javelinas. So the Javelinas do their job. They're going to force the Rattlers to start from their own 37-yard line.
Yeah, it really was a good punt by Vela there. It's just one of those situations that the Rattlers were able to make the best of a bad situation. Mm-hmm. Now instead of being at their own, they were going to be behind, maybe inside the 28, 29 now.
Yeah,
they're over
here. They did about a good 10 yards, yes. So it was a right call. It was a right call in either case, but again, I am agreeing with you. With Vela made a tremendous punt right there, and it's going to be an end around, a lot of running room, sidestepping a defender and then getting hit from behind, and the ball comes out loose, and who recovers it? I think Sherryland's going to get it. Well, Do the Javelinas. No, Javelinas. Sir, I am corrected. The Javelinas forced their second turnover of the game. And for the second time, the Javelinas are going to start on the Sherryland High side of the football field. So golden opportunity before the half awaits the Javelina offense.
You know, this game keeps going on, Javi, and it's just the more I get impressed with this Javelina defense, right?
They're flying everywhere.
They're flying all over to the football. They're able to make plays, and they're making the best again of their situation. Mm-hmm. Can the offense capitalize, right? They're in a great spot with 2 minutes left, 2 minutes and 20 seconds.
Well, right now, you know, that's been the difference. The offense has not gotten going, and on first down, actually, they're going backwards. Contreras gets sacked, a big-time sack, all the way back to his own 45-yard line.
Yeah, that's definitely not something you want to see. Here we see on the juniors' replay, yeah, just a great job by the entire defense. And that's what they teach, right? The first guy holds them, sticks them, give them the hit.
Yes.
The rest of the troops got to go over there and rip that ball away from them.
And the grease pig came out, and the Javelinas were able to recover it. And now, you know, they still have a great opportunity here. You know, it's second and 21. They lost 11 on that quarterback sack. But if that offensive line can just give Contreras a little bit of time, I think they'll be fine. And on second down, they're going to run it, and perhaps they're going to lose one more yard. So
timeout.
Quickly,
Sherry High. Second timeout of the first half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, two plays, two tackles for a loss. So the Rattlers defense, you know, they're selling out right now. They're going hard, getting into the backfield, making it very difficult for the Javelinas. You know, the Javelinas right now have 51 yards passing. But the big thing is, of course, with those quarterback sacks, you know, we count against that against the running game. They're at 6 total yards.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of tough, right? On that first down play, it was a huge loss. Contreras was trying to roll out, but I mean, it was kind of doomed from the get-go. He tried to go back the other way, but the pocket by that time had completely collapsed. There was really nowhere for him to go. And then on second down, you know, the idea was there. You know, they had their linemen's making some, you know, there was an opportunity on that play specifically. But like you said, you know, Sherryland's just flying to the ball, just like the Javelinas defense has been.
Well, it'll be third and 21 now. We got a couple deep safeties playing center field for the Rattlers, anticipating a long pass. And right now there's a young man wide open. They're going to run it with Salas, and Salas is going to jet forward, run as hard as he can towards the midfield stripe. He will get there, so it's a good pickup of 6, but
time
out of the first down.
Sherry High, their final timeout of the first half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, the Rattlers get a timeout. That's their final one. And, you know, and of course, they're setting this up. You know, they've got a minute 12 to go. They're going to force the Javelinas to punt.
Yeah, they're right at midfield, so that's plenty of time. You know, for them to try to come out with some points before the half ends. On the defensive side, you got to keep doing what you're doing, right? Mm-hmm. The Javelinas have been playing tough, playing hard.
Yes, they have.
They got to keep that mindset. They got to keep grinding. And if they can walk out of here, even if they're able to stop holding the 3 points, it's still going to be, you know, a victory for that defense.
And that's a key right there. You want to give yourself an opportunity to get to the second half, to get late in the game, to get into the final minutes of the fourth quarter with a chance, one big play, and possibly steal a win. Because right now, you know, Sherryland's been a hit the whole time, 6-0. High snap, gathered well. Vela with a booming punt. It's going to possibly, well, it's going to check up, and it takes a favorable Rattler roll, and it's going to be down at about the 32-yard Rattlers, but no timeouts, and they got a long way to go.
Yeah, they do. That was a good punt. Definitely not a great roll, though, for the Javelinas. As you said, it did roll in favor for the Rattlers. But they still got to get down there, right? They've got just over a minute left. I think the Javelinas still have enough left in the tank for the first half anyways to be able to make a stop here.
But we'll see what Quirrell and the
Rattlers.
Offense have in store here. Carroll looking, look, he's got a man wide open, and there's, well, no, it is not. It was too easy of an opportunity for Eduardo Mendoza. You know, that's one of those where you're thinking six before you make the reception, and of course, as any receiver goes, that's a no-no, incomplete pass.
Yeah, here on the Junior's replay, it was a good route. He was all by himself, and I think you're going to see right here, oh, he just maybe took his eyes off it just a little bit, right? He saw all that green, all that room he had to run, and he's going to be killing himself over that one. But, you know, the Javelinas have got to take that break, and it's second down.
Yeah, just a missed opportunity, and I'm sure that young man's going to make a lot more receptions in his career. Krell looking, directing, sitting strong. Finally gets flushed out. Good job and a good push right there out of bounds. So that'll stop the clock with 48 seconds.
Yeah, I think that was Lupe Garcia forcing him out of bounds. Mm-hmm. Only gained 2 yards. The clock did stop, right? So that does help out the Rattlers a little bit. But no harm there. He only picked up 2 yards. It's still the third and long situation for the Rattlers.
And, of course, with 48 seconds, the Javelinas still have 2 timeouts, but I think at this point in juncture of the half, you just simply want to get a stop here.
Yeah, if it takes us the half, let's do it. Let's regroup.
Mm-hmm. So taking their time are the Rattlers. And, of course, you know, tonight we have packed the house. We've got, you know, the elementaries. And I want to say give a shout-out to Miss Garza, the principal at Kelly Farr Elementary. And thank you for and your students and your staff for being out here. And of course, my favorite of Kelly Farr Elementary staff is my lovely wife, Azucena. So I'm glad she's out here representing Kelly Farr Elementary. And again, future Javelinas in the house. And there we see great views of the kids and the fans. And there is Kelly Farr Elementary. So hi, right back at you.
Yeah, it's always nice when you see the kids out here. And when they're not only when they're here, but when they're out here having a great time, as clearly you can see them right now, they're enjoying themselves.
And no better place than PSJA State. This is a great venue right here. A lot of people say, well, it's between us and possibly Weslaco. I got to hand it to PSJA High.
We could easily be biased.
Stadium, yes. Nothing wrong with being a little biased.
Nothing wrong with it whatsoever.
And I think we got better football teams than Weslaco does too. But I'm just throwing it out there. And, you know, I get a little grief when I say sometimes stuff like that, you know, from all sides. I got some ugly looks from our, you know, production team over there.
Yeah,
and of course, Danny has a lot of family, a lot of friends, a lot of kids that went through Weslaco. And I believe Danny's heading to Austin, if I'm correct, for a graduation. So that's huge. San Antonio. Close enough. There we go. The Javelinas are going to gain about 5 to 6 yards, maybe a little bit more, up past the 30, up to the 31-yard line.
Yeah, if they give them that spot, they're going to be looking at about 2nd and 2. Clock's still running down, so it looks like they're going to just go ahead and take this into the half.
Yes.
Not try to risk anything. Yeah, so now we're down to 5 seconds here, so it looks like it's going to be the final play.
I'd like to see the old Hail Mary. Just rip it. Well, they're going to keep it on the ground, and that'll be Luengo. He gets a first down, but, of course,
the end of the first half.
The end of the first half, as we see the officials say it. Well, folks, it's been a very entertaining first half. It's 6-0 in favor of the visitors from Sherryland. The Sherryland High Rattlers 6, the PGA Southwest Javelina 0, as we're going to send it to the halftime entertainment. Enjoy.
And we are back at PSJA Stadium here at the field level, and we're ready for the halftime show. I'm going to introduce to you first the Sherryland High School Band. They're going to be performing a tune called Hypnotic under the direction of Mr. Mark Perea.
And the Javelina Marching Band will be performing the Veterans Day Salute Enduring Love Movement 3 by Tony Flores, the Southwest Director.
Let's enjoy the show, and we'll be right back in 28 minutes.
The Halftime Show is presented by Mockingbird Transport.
Go
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Entering center field to perform for you tonight are your award-winning Sherryland High School Diamonds. The Diamonds are under the direction of Miss Monica Martinez Lopez and assistant Renda Del Bosque. Introducing your 2023-2024 Sherryland Diamond Officers. Lieutenant Carla Vargas. Co-Captain Melanie Camacho. Captain Natseli Camacho. And your 2023-2024 Major, Cassandra Caratachea. Now sit back and enjoy the halftime show that the Diamonds have prepared for you tonight. Sherryland Diamonds, the floor is all yours.
Our Diamond of the Week is Kaylin Ortiz. And being that tonight's football game concludes our 2023 football season, our Diamond of the Season is Lovely Flores.
Are you ready for beer?
Let the bass kick.
Award-winning Sherryland High School Mighty Rattler Band. This evening, the Mighty Rattler Band will be performing their state show, Hypnotic. The band is under the field direction of drum majors Madison Hernandez, Andrea Van Tyne, and Renata Martinez. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the sounds of the Mighty Rattler Band's pop music hits.
Thank you.
watch her. When she's done moving, you start. Okay.
Can't see that she's a black magic woman, she's trying to make a double out of me. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Start messing around with your tricks. No, don't turn your back on me, baby. I just might pick up my magic stick.
This concludes our halftime activities. The Sherland High School Marching Band is directed by Mark Brea, Patrick Schmidt, Beth Van Epps, Frank Salinas, Percussion Tech, Hector Villanueva, and Color Guard Instructor Orly Gaitan. The Diamonds Dance Team is under the direction of Ms. Monica Martinez. The Rattler Band would like to thank Ms. Lori Garza and the Superintendent of Sherland Schools, Ms. Maria Vidauri, and most importantly, the fans. We thank you for your support, and we hope you have enjoyed our performance. Congratulations to both bands on a great season, and go Rattlers!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's halftime entertainment. Please direct your attention to the center of the field. This evening, the Sapphires are accompanied by an amazing and talented group of young performers, the Junior Sapphires. On behalf of the PSGA Southwest Early College High School, We extend a special thanks to all participants, their parents, and their dance directors that helped make this performance possible. Now let's put our hands together and welcome the future Sapphires to our game this evening. Take it away, boys and girls.
We're stepping in, we're not stepping out.
Junior Sapphires.
Thank you.
Taking the field is the pride of the Southwest, the Javelina Marching Band. Tonight, the Javelina Band will be performing a medley of military marches in honor of our United States veterans. If you have served or are currently serving in the military, please stand and be recognized. This Armed Forces medley will recognize the Army, the Marines, and the Navy. Please sit back and enjoy. Performing a portion of their 2023 marching show entitled An Enduring Love. The Javelina Band was an Area G finalist in La Jolla, Texas on Saturday, October 28th. Take it away, band. Thank you. drum majors for the Javelina Band are Devani Ocañas, Cintia Guzman, and Andrea Morales.
And that was a great halftime performance by both of the bands, the Javelina Band and, of course, the Sherla Rattler Band. And the game's still up on the air. Rattlers are up 6-0. It could go either way. Let's hope for the best outcome for our Javelina team. Hopefully they can say goodbye to the season with a victory here at home. Let's take it upstairs. Javi Martinez and Isaac Serna are ready to bring the action of the second half.
The halftime show is presented by Mockingbird Transport.
Well, folks, welcome back to PSJA Stadium. Hope you enjoyed the halftime festivities. And right now, as we come out of halftime, you know, it's Sherland High 6, PSJ Southwest 0. And Isaac, I was impressed, Isaac, with you know, both bands and, you know, the dancers out there. But that rendition of Black Magic Woman, that's pretty neat. I have never, you know, been involved at a halftime that has an actual singer like that.
Well, not only that, but they were singing great, and the people that were on the guitar, too, they were killing
it. Yes. Yeah, I was impressed. I tell you what, great time here at PSJA Stadium, and great job by the both bands, both sets of dancers. And right now, you know, it's back to business as we see PSJ Southwest take the field. Of course, they're trailing 6-0 right now, Sherland High, the visitors with the upper hand. And right now, you know, stat-wise, they have the upper hand as well. They have 203 total yards offensively, while the Javelinas have 78. And, you know, the Javelinas have only 3 first downs, but Sherland only has 7. It's been an awkward game where both teams, I think, they've had chances, but nobody can really capitalize other than that one score, you know, early on in the first quarter. It's been tough.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Javier. It's been a lot of missed opportunities for both teams, right? The coming right out of the gate, the Rattlers threw an interception, and the Javelinas were unable to capitalize on that one. They had great field position.
Yes.
Then on the flip side, there were a few moments where the Rattlers had great field position, but the Javelinas stepped up. As you said, the score is still 6-0, but that one was almost actually like on a busted play.
Yes, it was as well. It was, you know, they got caught napping, if you will, busted coverage. There was a little pass out of the backfield to the running back, and, you know, he just caught it. There was nobody inside. He just jogged in, waltzed in for a touchdown, if you will. And, of course, the Javelinas, as we mentioned, they had first and goal at the 9 early on, trying to, you know, return the favor, trying to tie it up, and they missed a field goal. So, you know, it's been missed opportunities from both teams. At the end of the day, both defensive units are playing extremely well. That's why we have a low-scoring, you know, defensive slugfest. It's 6-0, but I get a feeling we're gonna see some explosive plays here in the second half, and I think this game's gonna get some more points. I you know, if I was a gambling man, I'd definitely take the over in the second half here.
Absolutely, I'm with you right there, Javi. It has been a great defensive game. Right now, we're gonna see the Rattlers. It's gonna be their turn to start a half with a offensive possession,
and it's a good kick, and does it stay in? No, it won't. So we'll start the second half with a penalty on the kicking unit.
Illegal kick out of bounds on the kicking team. The ball will be placed at the 30-yard line. First down.
Thank you to our premier sponsor, FAR Crime Stoppers. If you need to report any suspicious activity, please call 787-TIPS. That's 787-TIPS.
Well, the Rattlers are going to get the ball at their own 30-yard line. Of course, they're led by their quarterback, Bo Krill. He has 135 yards passing on 23 attempts. The Javelinas, though, they've held the Rattlers to just 68 yards rushing. So, you know, I think it's going to be up to Bo Krill to get this offense moving. And on first down, you know, he's there with a running back. It's a bad snap over Krill's head. And he's going to pick it up, going to get pummeled in the backfield. He should have just sat on it. Slow to get up as a quarterback, but he will get up. Big-time collision, big-time play by the Javelina defense.
Yeah, tough kid. I'm just kind of glad to see that he was able to get back up after that. That was the bad snap from the get-go. There we see UT Health Rio Grande Valley replay, right? It goes over his head. At that point, you got to take it down. Right there specifically, I think maybe he thought he had a chance. Great job, though, by the Javelina defense. And now it's literally, I'd say, second in about 2 weeks maybe for a first down.
Well, Andrick Lopez, you know, he took a shot. He goes, you know what? This is a free one on the quarterback and took full advantage. And on second and forever, the running back, Santiago Longoria, is going to get good yardage. You know, some of those back after the quarterback sack.
Yeah, he's been running tough all night, you know, with the few carries that he's been given. But he's been doing something with it, right? He's showing his toughness right there, and it's a good run by him.
Replay by UT Health RGV.
Well, you know, with that tackle for a loss on, you know, the quarterback sack, if you will, of 19 yards, the Rattlers only have 55 yards rushing and only 190 yards total offense. So it'll be third down. Quarterback wings it out. The reception is finally made after a juggling catch right there. And the Javelinas defense quickly corralled the receiver, but then again, we have another penalty.
I think it's going to be against the Rattlers holding on one of the receivers, blocking a little too good on that play.
Okay, so we'll see. If it is, do you decline it and have a fourth and two or three?
Holding. Offense. Number 9. 10-yard penalty. Spot the foul. Replay third down.
Well, I'm mistaken.
Direction. The penalty is declined.
There you go.
Okay, there we go.
Yes, and I was about to say, that's the first down. That's the initial marker right there. So it's actually fourth and very long. It was third and
23.
So now it's third and about 14. So definitely a decline situation. And the Rattlers are going to punt. So the Javelina defense, as they've been doing all evening, they're keeping their football team with a chance. And now it's up to the offense. Let's see that Southwest offense can get anything going. Taking our time, though, I'm not sure. Well, they got 3 seconds on the play clock. They better hurry. They finally do, and they throw
a flag. Going for
and
a
they
fake.
Faked it, and the reception is made.
But there's a flag, Javi.
I don't think they got it off in time, to be honest with you. This may be a delay of game. Why they waited so long, I am not sure. It's a delay
or
of game
or motion?
False start. Yes.
False start.
Illegal formation. Yeah. Offense. Too many men in the backfield. 5 yards. Replay. Fourth down.
Yeah, that's a bummer for the Rattlers,
yes.
But, man, what a break for the Javelinas again. But that's a gutsy call.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to start the second half, that's crazy. And it worked beautifully, but, again, you know, they just were not lined up properly. That's a 5-yard penalty. Javelinas will gladly take that. So, do you fake it again?
I wouldn't, but, man,
you
I mean.
Dice once, I don't think you do it back
I don't even
place.
Know that I would have done it on fourth and 14. But, I mean, in any case, they did it, and they ran it successfully.
Yeah, and it worked perfect. It was a nice pass, great design. Just
somebody wasn't lined
was
up wrong. Yeah,
somebody did not get to their spot. Well, they are going to punt it, and heavy pressure on the punter. It's a short punt, so the Javelinas should have the ball near their own 40-yard line. Let's see. Well, that's got to be the tastiest commercial I've ever seen. Junior Supermarket. I love it. Always gets me pumped up for the weekend. Hopefully the Javelinas are pumped up here in the second half. I see a lot of penalty flags being thrown. The Javelinas manufactured 2 yards on
Holding.
That run.
Offense, number 65. 10 yards, replay, first down.
But it is all going to come back.
Yeah, offensive line seems to be a little more disciplined. You know, you holding happens on every play, right? That's what everybody says.
Yeah, that's absolutely right.
And as a former offensive lineman, that is absolutely true. There's holding on every single play. You just can't be as obvious when you're doing it. Keep your hands inside. It's tough, but.
Yeah, that's the key. They say as long as you're within the shoulder pads, you're okay. Once you extend your hands out or on the outside,
right.
Well, they're going to call it because everybody can see it then.
Yes.
So, you know, it's a call. It's against the Javelinas, and the Javelinas are going to break free. Try to get about half of those penalty yards back so they cross midfield once again. They're at the Rattlers' 47-yard line.
Yeah, that was a nice little run there by Adan Lopez, unable to break free. They had him wrapped around by his foot, brought him down, but, you know, it was still a nice run. They got, like you said, about half of those penalty yardage back, looking at second and 15. And it's kind of the same situation, right? The quarterback and the offense looking over here, they're trying to see. The coaches are looking to see what the defense is kind of giving them, what kind of formation. So that's kind of why you see these plays taking a while. A lot of people think spread formation is always a fast pace, not necessarily.
Well, it'll be the pistol. It'll be quick swing out pass. And we've got another penalty flag thrown. So this one will be on hold as it is a one-yard penalty. And more than likely,
illegal formation. Offense. Too many men in the backfield. That penalty be declined. Third down.
And I was about to say it's either illegal formation or a false start because that was thrown really quickly.
Yeah, you can't have five guys, you know, lined up in the backfield. It's just one of those situations where you got to make sure you're lined up properly, knowing if you're on the line or not.
A lot of movement now by the Javelinas. It'll be third and 15. Rather short 15. Maybe a third and 13. Bad snap. Quarterback rolls out to his near sideline, and he's just going to run out of real estate. Well, he tosses it. And it's going to be incomplete, though, as the ball sails out of bounds.
Yeah, quarterback was in a lot of trouble on that one, though. But, you know, good heads-up play, getting it out before he had the chance to get sacked. So another fourth down, though, for the Javelinas, right? So that looks like they're bringing their punting unit out.
Yes.
If they can get them pinned back.
Right.
It's going to be a good situation.
Yeah, it'll be a win. Flipping the field and getting themselves, their defense.
What do you think? You think they're going to try a fake here?
I wouldn't. I'd go percentage. You know, your defense is playing well.
Absolutely.
Pin them deep. Get a three and out once again, as they did on the Javelinas' first attempt. High snap. Good job right there by Vela. Big punt.
And oh, get it.
They're going to get it, and they're going to mark it down at about the 20-yard line.
Thank you to our premier sponsors, the Wing Stadium and ACT RGV.
Well, after a couple of commercial breaks right there, the Rattlers are pinned deep. I was hoping it'd be inside the 15, maybe, but it, you know, took a Rattler bounce.
A quick bounce. They stopped it before it could have taken a bigger bounce.
So the Rattlers will start at their own 21-yard line. Of course, they have a 6-0 lead. We're in the third quarter. Final game of District 16-5A Division 2 between PJ Southwest and Sherland High. Both teams looking for their first win in district. So a lot at stake here tonight. And be a horse collar tackle? I believe not.
Might have got him under the shoulder pad.
So nothing doing right there. It'll be second and 10.
Yeah, it looks like they stopped him right at the line of scrimmage. I believe that was Adan Lopez making the tackle for the Javelinas. And so it's a good situation right now defensively for the Javelinas. If they've got these guys at a second and 10, they're still backed up inside their 20.
And we've already seen 23 pass attempts from Bo Krell. He has only 135 yards passing, though. He's been really hit or miss, and he's missed some big opportunities. So let's see if the Javelina defense can continue to put pressure on Krell. But it's that the Rattlers are going to elect to run the ball. They're going to get good yardage as the running back, Mario Mendoza, gets upended.
Yeah, Mario got some good yardage on that one. He's going to make it very manageable third down for the Rattlers. We're looking probably about third and 5.
That was Mario Mendoza's just second carry of the ball game. He only has 5 yards. And, of course, the Rattlers, offensively, they have 69 yards rushing. So the Javelinas have done an excellent job stopping the run and limiting the passing game of Bo Krell. Bo looks. Telling people to go somewhere, and he's going to loft it up, and is it a reception? Yes, it is. He threw it into double, triple coverage, but the receiver still comes up with a huge grab all the way at the Javelina 31-yard line. That's big-time football right there.
That was an insane catch there by Longoria, man. Wow. Talk about a 50-50 ball between two defenders, And he came down with it on a big time, and you know, another big time throw there. Here we see on the UT Health replay. He's just rolling out. He had some time. What a great ball, man. Look at that spiral that dies down. Look at that 50-50 ball. Great timing by Longoria on that jump to catch it at his highest
point.
And
the key was that he high-pointed. And he's got another opportunity, but this time the pass is incomplete. Great job right there by Jaden Mejia. Intended receiver Bruno Cavazos.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of like we've been saying earlier. Bo Krill has been letting it sling.
Yes.
Right? And he's got some missed throws, but he's also had a lot of missed catches, though.
That's the other thing, too. I'll give credit to the receiving core of the Rattlers. They're very fast, but they need to, you know, be more sure-handed, bottom line. I think they've had some great opportunities that slip by their hands, and the Javelinas have been able to make the stops when they have to, and right now they're going to have to do it once again, but a big bruising run. And off to the races is Longoria, and Longoria is going to shrug off and run over another would-be tackler. Longoria finally gets pushed out of bounds at the 6-yard line. So a 25-yard run by Longoria there for the Rattlers.
Yeah, that was a big-time run by Longoria there. He had a lot of room from his big uglies up front. And then it's just a lot of shifting, finding, you know, ways to get around. And finally just forced out of bounds. He almost got in there. It would have been a touchdown right there. Yeah. But
and actually he did stay in bounds up to about the 3-yard line. Well, they're going to spot him at the 6. So it'll be first and goal at the 6 for the Rattlers, trying to extend the 6-point lead with 5:15 remaining in the third quarter. Well, Krell looked like he was going to go under center. Decides not to. He's got a man open, and he's going to hit him in stride. Nice little pass right there to Eduardo Mendoza. Touchdown, Rattlers.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what the Rattlers are going to do now. Are they going to try to go for 2 points to actually make it a 14-0 score?
I'm pretty sure they are. You know, they got that set up again. They're going to quick snap it. They're going to throw it on the outside, and that just feels incomplete, so it'll be no good, the 2-point conversion. So with 5:10 remaining in the third quarter here at beautiful PSJA Stadium, it's Sheridan High 12, PSJA Southwest 0.
So we'll see how the Javelina offense is going to answer back. You know, it was a tough break right there on that drive for the Javelina defense, but I still think, you know, they've got a lot to not, you know, worry about too much defensively, right? They've got that bend but don't break mentality right now. And it's still working, right? Even though they did score.
Mm-hmm. Well, the backbreaker on that drive was just that pass that Krell threw
both
up for grabs
plays,
for 43
plays
yards.
Made.
So, you know, they're just two plays that, as you mentioned, it's 50-50. Things
right.
go well. It gets tipped. It goes through his hands. And the Javelinas are probably receiving a punt right now. But instead, it's a 12-point ball game, a 12-point lead now for the Rattlers as they get set to kick off. So it's vital here for the offense of the Javelinas to get something going. Their defense has done the job all evening long. Now it's time for the offense to put some points on the board.
Yeah, you said it, Javi. Longoria came down with that catch, and the very next play he has that big run that set them up with a nice first and goal.
It's a pooch kickoff, and it's going to be filled at near the 30-yard. A lot of running room, but quickly closes, but still on their feet are the Javelinas' return team, and the Javelinas are going to have excellent field position around their own 41-yard line.
Yeah, Rattlers are trying to make a pitch that they got that ball out before his forward progress was ruled.
Yeah, so they blew the whistle, so the Javelinas...
The rule on the field is forward progress has been established. First down, Southwest.
Yes, sir, you called it to perfection there, so the Javelinas will have it first and 10 from their own 42-yard line.
And it's a great spot for them to start at, right? They're close to midfield. They're not backed up in their own territory. Let's see if they can make the most of it on this drive.
Well, the Javelinas are looking for a big play. They haven't had it. Their longest play from scrimmage is 15 yards this evening. And on first down, they're going to struggle just to get back to the line of scrimmage, and they will not. It'll be a tackle in the backfield back at the 39-yard line. So it's a loss of 3 on first down. So second and 13 for the Javelina offense.
Yeah, Javelina's having just a little bit of time, a hard time getting their running game going. You see right there wasn't really a whole lot of room for the running back. That was Adan Lopez.
And the key, Isaac, I think it's quite simply, you know, you got three down linemen, defensive linemen for the Rattlers, but as you mentioned, their linebackers are the key this mm-hmm. evening. They're shooting the gaps, and there's just nowhere to run. And there you see it once again. I mean, they're in the backfield quickly, but avoiding the defenders are the Javalinas, and that's a tremendous run. Great effort right there. Great execution. And, of course, you had to use the speed of Caleb Torres to outrun that defense because they were in the backfield quickly.
Yeah, that was a great job there by Caleb Torres, looking at using his vision, kind of having a stutter step, but he gets around and able to break from that tackle. And he makes this a very good, you know, third and a short yard situation for the Javalinas.
Well, he picked up 12. He needed 13. And drawing
that
outside,
should be a free play.
It's a free play. And instead, it's going to be a draw and maybe a horse collar now. No, they're just going to say he swung out of bounds. Well, it looked like the defense
offsides.
Was offsides.
Defense, yes. Number 99, 5 yards, third down. Correction, the foul results in a first down.
There you go. I was going to say, wow, okay. Keep it at third, but no. They needed one. They got five on the penalty, so it'll be a Javelina first down. They're going to move the ball forward up to the 44-yard line. So it's looking good right now for the Javalinas.
Yeah, good job by the Javalinas using their snap count to kind of draw these guys to go offsides. I would have liked to seen one of those, you know, it's one of those situations where when you're able to draw them offsides, you know it's a free play, take your shot downfield.
Yes. Throw it up there for grabs. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter what happens.
It's incomplete
yeah.
or intercepted. And they're going to air it out, and the reception is made on the far sideline and ducking underneath the tackler. Good, nifty job right there by Peter Galvan. As they say, stay low, young man, and he did. He picks up about 2 to 3 more yards after contact there.
Yeah, that was a great job. Able to just make the catch clean and then maneuver around right here. He's going to dip under. Good job. That was great. That was Kyler Abrigul.
Up to the 38-yard line. It's a good job right there. And this is what you want to see.
Absolutely.
Second down, and now you've got options. It's second and four. You can run. You can pat. Now the defense is on their heels. They don't know what to expect. And the Javalinas,
another,
you know, they run
down.
It right down their throat right there. And more than enough for a first down. So a big run right there by the Javalinas offense. Great job by that offensive line. And that should be, well, do we have a penalty?
I don't believe so.
No, we don't. They're just
moving,
moving the chains slowly. There we go.
Yeah, the Javalinas right now, they're building up some good momentum. They got to keep it going. Stick with what's working, all right? Don't try to get too cute. Don't outsmart yourself. Keep that momentum going. You're driving down the field.
Yeah, that's the key right now. They're hitting them with short slant passes and quick dives up the
quick
middle.
Quick stuff, quick game.
And they're going to do it again. Off tackle and a big gaping hole. And that offensive line really starting to hum now. And good yardage right there on the carry. This time it was Adan Lopez. And Adan Lopez gets good yardage. Now we see some people shoving and pushing. And quickly the coaching staff is out there to make sure that it does not escalate. We've already lost one player.
Yeah, Don Lopez looks upset about something. And one of the coaches kind of had to calm him down and say, hey, man, we already lost one guy. We need you. We need you to help us out. I really like the way he's been running, right? He sees that split open, and he plants his foot, and he gets up, right? And he was able to get some good yardage there. Let's see if we see. Yeah, I guess he's not like a little extra shoving.
Yes.
Yeah. It can get you a little frustrated there.
I think the tackle enough is enough, and then you get punched in the gut afterwards. That's tough. Man, getting punched are the Javalinas as that defense really gets into the backfield. Tackle made at the 30, so loss of 4 on that one. That's a big play right there. It was a very manageable second down. That's going to be a third and long, 3rd and 7 to be exact, as we're under 2 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. And, of course, with Sherland leading 12-0, it's vital here. It's very important for the Javalinas to get something. Get yourself on the board somehow.
Yeah, I totally agree with you there, Javi. It was, like you said, they were about 2nd and 3, maybe 2nd and 4. They end up with a 3-yard loss. And it was a well-timed blitz there by the defense. So let's see, 3rd and down.
Well, they're going to fake the run. They're going to air it out. And it's a great setup.
Go,
the Javalinas. Can he get inside?
He,
touchdown.
Oh, I don't know. I think he's just
yes,
he's in. Let's go.
Peter Galvan races to the corner pylon. Great setup, great execution. Galvan uses his blazing speed and just does get into the end zone. Touchdown, Javalinas.
Yeah, it was a great job. The quarterback pretty much was on the right side of the field. Looks back, basically a throwback play all the way across.
They sold that tremendously. Here we see on the UT Health Rio Grande Valley replay. And there he is. After that, Isaac, he's off to the races. He can see the pylon.
Yeah, he's definitely showing his athleticism there. And oh, wow.
He does get in there. Great camera coverage, as always, by KTRI. And the extra point is going to be just inches over the crossbar. Folks, we've got a game now. It's anybody's ball game. The game still can go either way. Sherryland 12, PSJ Southwest 7 with a minute 15 remaining in the third quarter. Fireworks. I knew there was going to be some scores, and we have them.
Yeah, that kick barely went through. Just barely made the crossbar. But it went over. That's all that matters,
that's all
right?
That matters.
And you said it, Javi. The Javelinas went out there. They needed to come away with
that
points.
That was huge.
And the best thing they did was to come out of there with a touchdown.
Well, and I'll tell you what, it was a great play call. And the quarterback sold it. You know, he was looking to the right. It was almost like if he was going to run it to the right.
The whole team.
Everybody
all
went
10
out.
Guys went to the right.
One man stayed. And that was Galvan. And the execution was perfect. He got him the ball quick enough to where he was able to use his speed, jet towards the end zone, and just barely by inches got in, crossed over the goal line for a touchdown. And then they barely made the extra point. So 12-7. I'm getting excited here.
I am too. I really feel like that score just kind of like, not only that, it hyped up their defense, right?
Yes.
Now it's going to give them that extra effort, extra energy, right? Now they're excited to go back out there, and they want to get that ball back to their offense.
Well, they're going to kick it off deep. And again, the reception was made, and the return man sips out of bounds. So big mistake right there. It's going to force the Rattlers to start from their own 12-yard line.
Yeah, that just kind of comes down to awareness. Unfortunately, he didn't know how close to the sideline he was when he's making that catch. I mean, I'm pretty sure he would have just rather let it go out of bounds.
Yeah, they would have had the ball at the 30.
Take it at the 30.
That's absolutely right. So, mental mistake. That means the Lady Luck is sitting on the Javelinas' side of the football field.
Yeah, here we see the Rattlers coming out. They're going to have it first and 10 at the 12-yard line. It'd be great to see if that defense can kind of come away with another turnover, maybe a pick six.
Now the question is, do the Rattlers stay aggressive, continue to throw the ball, or are they going to try to run the ball and eat up a lot of clock? And on first down, it's the latter. Run the ball past the 15, up to the 16, gain of 4, second and 6, as we quickly approach the one-minute mark of the third quarter.
That's actually a really good play call by the Rattlers. I like it a lot, right? It was an option read. Everybody was expecting that handoff to go to Longoria like every carry has been. Bo Krell pulls it out. He only manages about 3 yards, but could have been a whole lot worse for the Javelinas.
So it's another running play, and picking up big chunk yards are the Rattlers. They're going to move the ball all the way to the 36-yard line. So two running plays, that's already netted 24 yards.
Yeah, Longoria has been running tough all night every chance he gets, and he picks up a big first down there. A little huffing and puffing, but he's given it everything he's got so far.
Well, were they elect to run another play? And I don't think they are. They're at 9 seconds, and I already see some Sherryland players
walking
to the other side.
Yeah.
And that'll be exactly what's going to happen. So, folks, we've got
it's
three quarters
quarter.
In the books. It is, as you see there, great graphics. Sherryland, the Rattlers, 12. Southwest, the Javelinas, 7.
Let's welcome our anchor partners, Freedom Bank and Junior Supermarket, proud sponsors of PSJ Athletics.
Oh, we're quickly back here at beautiful PSJ Stadium. Again, a proud production of KTR. I'm Javi Martinez, and Isaac, it's been a pleasure working with you once again. It's been how many years? Maybe five, six years?
Maybe about five. We were talking earlier. I think our last one was in 2016.
And
man, KTRI was doing the great job then. They're even doing more stuff now. It's just crazy, like, how you guys have evolved.
It's grown. It's a great production. Of course, Mark Vasquez is spearheading that, and, you know, and I'm just honored and grateful and blessed to be part of it. And, you know, I'm happy that you're here. Of course, Jonathan Gongora, you know, my main partner in crime, you know, he's got to do some basketball duties. I was disappointed in him, but, you know, hey, he's got to do his job first. That one pays a little more than this one.
He's all over the place. Oh, yeah.
And go over there. Yes.
I think he's doing basketball, and then he's also doing, like, track and cross country.
And he just got done with football. Yeah. So I don't envy the guy. I'm going to be honest with you. So the Rattlers began this drive from their own 36-yard line. After a gain of 3 or 4, they're going to keep it on the ground again. This time they're going to lose about half a yard. And that's my point that I was getting to earlier, saying, are they going to start to regress here? Not regress, but just be more conservative and start to run the ball more. And, of course, you have the lead. If you can kill clock and pick up a few first downs, there's no way Southwest is going to come back.
Yeah, I think that is the option that they're going to take. You know, the times that they have run it, they have seen success, especially when it's been going to Longoria. So they're not too worried about staying away from that.
Well, they're going to air it out on third down, and great coverage right there. Excellent coverage, forcing the quarterback to throw it out of bounds. And, again, that was Jaden Mejia with the coverage on number 9, Eduardo Mendoza. Mendoza's been targeted quite a few times, just coming up empty, though. So fourth down. Avalina defense, they get the job done once again, and now it's up to the offense. If they can get themselves into the end zone, they will take the lead for the first time this evening.
Yeah, we see the punting unit making their way out here.
Timeout, PSJ Southwest, first time out of the second half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Champions don't settle for less. Knock out injuries with UT Health RGV Sports Medicine, the official sports medicine doctor for the UT RGV Vaqueros and PSJA ISD. UT Health RGV, keeping Vaqueros and you in the game.
Well, after a UT Health Rio Grande Valley timeout, interesting, they call a timeout on 4th and 7. Mm-hmm. And maybe the Javelinas are anticipating
another fake.
And they're lining up with an unusual formation. So hopefully that timeout discussed it. And right now, you know, we got players moving all over the place. And, of course, the key is, are they lined up properly? We're
going to
find out right now.
I see 7.
And they do punt it away. And, of course, they're going to punt it to the side where they have a lot of men. And it's a good punt, and the Javelinas are going to take over around their own 30-yard line.
Do you need fast, affordable internet? The City of FAR will be providing high-speed internet starting as low as $25 a month. And for PSJ households, you will receive free internet. Call 956-402-2000 for more information.
Well, folks, the Javelinas have 2 timeouts. They got plenty of time, though. 10.5 minutes remaining here in the final quarter, the fourth quarter. They just cut into the lead. They were trailing 12-0. They cut it in half, 12-7. So they only trailed by 5. So a touchdown in all essence. They take the lead. A field goal puts them within 2. So they're looking for 6. And on first down, they're going to air it out. Nice little pass. Not much doing. And the receiver gets hit hard right there. He took a punishment to Caleb Salas. But he holds on to the ball. Picks up about 2 yards.
Yeah, it was a tough 2 yards, though. But he held on to it. Gripped it tight, went to the floor, and it's positive yards. Right here we see on the replay, quarterback gets around, nice catch there. Caleb Torres just hangs on to it, is able to, you know, like we said, it was tough 2-3 yards, but they're in front of the sticks. They're not behind the chains. They just got to keep it moving.
And, of course, that was Ivan Ramirez and Vladimir Trevino teaming up there where the tackle, bad snap, quarterback has to scramble. Tossie's got a man wide open in the near flat right here. And good run. He stays in bounds. Twinkle toeing down the sideline. And he gets a stiff arm, perhaps. And there's a horse collar tackle as well. My goodness, what a headsy play by the quarterback. Adan Lopez miraculously heads downfield, stays in bounds. And now let's hope he's okay after a horse collar tackle. So that should tack on half the distance to the goal, the Javelinas move the ball all the way to the Rattlers' 17-yard line.
Yeah, they're going to be set up in great field position. Let's see, that's what the call is.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 15. Half a distance to the goal, first down.
Yeah, great situation there. They're going to be set up at a first and goal. Great position, only down 5 points.
Timeout, injury.
So here right there, I mean, he's able to just kind of break away. He's getting there, gets there, and then you kind of see right here, there's the face mask, and we kind of get confused how it does kind of look like. Yeah, it could have been the horse. Well, he got the jersey there. But we knew it was going to be on the defense because it was Lopez all by himself, surrounded right by about seven Rattlers. And he's back up.
Yes,
that's good to see because they're gonna need him. He'll have to sit out of play. So hopefully it's nothing too bad, and then he can get back out there and help them out. But that was a great play. Huge, 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 huge.
So it'll be a 51-yard pickup and then the penalty flag. But who threw the ball? Well, I guess it was Luengo.
That was Luengo, yeah.
Yeah, it was Luengo. So it'll be 150 yards passing by the Javelinas offensively. Luengo with 112 of those. He's going to fire into the end zone. Touchdown, is
it? That's a great. That's
yes,
Caleb
sir,
Torres.
Caleb Salas right at the end zone. They wave it as a touchdown, and the Javelinas for the first time this evening. It's been a while for the Javelina Nation to have the lead on the scoreboard, but they have it right now.
I want to see the Javelinas go for two here, right? It's going to put them, if they're able to get it, it's going to put them up 15 to 12. Looks like they're just going to go for the extra point, though. The only reason I say go for two is because now you're going to put pressure on the
yes.
Rattlers to have to score for that touchdown because.
Yeah, in all this, the extra point is good. It's going to make it 14-12. A field goal beats you.
Right.
So I think the wise thing was going for two, but instead they settled for one. No big deal. Javelinas needed 14-12.
Has the face. Defense, number 43. The foul will be enforced on the kickoff. The extra point was good.
And then that's going to help the Javelinas too. Right now they're going to get an extra 15. Here we see the replay. And just a great, oh, man, that jumped right into the hands of Caleb. Great job. Just went over the outstretched hands of the defender, too. I mean, it could have been tipped.
It went over the defender. It went over possibly the intended receiver, Yair Ahmad. And Salas was where he had to be. He makes a touchdown reception. Add insult to injury on the extra point. The Rattlers get penalized. So the Javelinas are going to be kicking off probably from the Rattler side of the football field. If not, pretty close. Do you onside kick here?
it's tough, right? I wouldn't kick it. Try to pin them back. Let your defense continue to do what they've been doing.
Most definitely. Yeah, aside from that one big play, as we mentioned earlier, the Rattlers haven't really sustained a big drive. It's 14-12, 9:28. Let me see a good look at Coach Leija there.
Yeah, so it looks like they're going to be kicking it from the 45-yard line.
Well, I think this is one of those where I think the kicker's got to pick somebody on the front line.
Right.
And just nail it at him and hope it bounces back towards
you.
Yeah,
there you go.
And you recover it. And if it doesn't, it scoots through everybody.
Right.
It goes maybe in the end zone, maybe it does not. But it gives you a chance. But we'll see. Fun times, interesting times here. The game has definitely turned. And it's a pooch kick. It's up for grabs. It's a fair catch.
No,
and
no.
Don't bump him. And there you go. Wow.
Yeah, that's just, you know, one of those unfortunate situations. You don't want to do that.
And honestly, he tried to hold back, but I think, you know, the juices are running very high. And, you know, it's a fair catch. So you got to leave him alone.
Is going.
You got to leave him alone.
Yeah.
Great kick, though. Excellent kick.
Kick catch interference on the kicking team. 15-yard penalty assessed to the dead ball spot. First down.
So now it looks like they're going to get the ball where it was actually kicked from. After the penalty, they're going to mark it down just right. Yeah, they're at the 42-yard line. So, in essence, the kick only gets them 3 yards.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. It's a net of 3 yards on the kickoff. So from the 42, the Rattlers have a great opportunity. It's a bad snap. Quarterback gets it. He's got a lot of running room now. He's going to get about 3 yards. So I tell you what, every play now is
crucial.
Near disaster or near greatness. I don't know which way you want to look at it.
It's almost as if there's nothing in between.
No, exactly. It's a crazy ball game. And, you know, that's one of the things that I always talk to with, you know, me and Jonathan always joke about. There's never a dull moment here. Every week there's just some craziness. And there you go. The Rattlers are going to break a big one. They're going to get past midfield all the way to the Javelinas 40-yard line. So 15-yard pickup right there. And that's tough to swallow right there. As we're under 9 minutes remaining in the ball game, the Javelinas need a stop as they lead by two. Rattlers, all they need is a field goal to regain the lead. And they're going to keep it on the ground, test that right side of that defensive front, and winning the battle again are the Rattlers, picking up 4 to 5 yards.
Yeah, Longoria is just a big bruising back. He's going to get right now. This is kind of where they're just kind of pounding the rock, right, trying to get in some good field position, see what they can kind of playing to what the defense is going to give them, right?
Right.
We still know that they're down 3 points. At some point, they're going to, you know, Bo Krell's going to want to, you know, get some passes in as well.
Well, I think both of them wanted to keep it, and that
did
tremendously well for the defense as big old number 79 clamps down on the running back, Carlo Escalera. That let him go. Big tackle right there.
A timeout for injury.
Yeah, Bo Krill was definitely trying to pull that one out. I think it was almost doomed either way.
Yes.
Whether it was the give or the take, you know, that play wasn't really going to go anywhere.
That'll be a loss of one. So it'll be third, loss of a couple, actually. It'll be
third and 11.
Third and 11 from the 41-yard line. And, of course, we're going to take a little break here in the action due to an injury timeout. And it gets interesting. You know, we got under 8 minutes to go. Sherryland still has all three timeouts. PSG Southwest, they called one on a fourth and seven when Rattlers were going to punt. Mm-hmm. So that may be a costly one at the end, but right now it's third and 11. There's a situation for the Rattlers. And, of course, going back to what we were talking about, what you brought up, it's a big key right there, is you just score a touchdown. You make it 13-12, you know, I think you're, in retrospect, you're better off going for the two. Whether you make it or not,
you're
up,
yeah.
13-12,
right.
14-12. A field goal beats you either way.
Either way.
Might as well go for two.
Absolutely. Force, you know, it's the best case scenario.
Yes.
But right. We'll see. So now what kind of situation do you think the Rattlers are in, right? It's third and long. In most situations, that's an obvious pass down. But are they treating this as two downs?
Yes,
or
definitely.
Let's see if we can pick up what we can. Let's see what fourth down
looks
like.
Yeah, I think it's fourth down territory. They're going to try to, at the very least, pick up half. And there's a pass. And, well, is it going to be face guarding? No, it's not. So, good coverage.
Yeah,
they're
going to
say, you
know,
it's just incidental. It hit them possibly in the back. So, it's going to be an incomplete pass. Great pass coverage right there. And, again, the other thing, it's interesting when you watch Bo Krell play football as a quarterback. He's got a cannon of an arm. He can run the ball. You know, he could have ran half the yards, as we talked about. I think the one thing he lacks is a little bit of patience and let the play develop, because that one maybe was thrown a little bit too early and didn't let the receiver just streak down the field and throw it deep. You know, just an observation, of course. Fourth down. Rattlers are going for it. Quirrell with a good pocket. Throws. He's got a man wide open, and that's what I'm talking about. That kid can throw. He's got major talent right there. Excellent ball right there and a great reception, and that'll move the chains for the Rattlers.
Yeah, that's a really, you know, tough break right there for the Javelinas, especially because it comes on a fourth down. But that was a great route, though, by the receiver. That was Sebastian Martinez, and you know, another great throw by Bo Krell.
Mm-hmm. Big time completion on fourth down. That takes a lot of guts and great execution. The drive continues for the Rattlers. Are going to keep it on the ground, try to eat up as much clock. But you got to make some tackles. Right now the Javelinas are just grabbing, trying to punch the ball loose. And instead, the big, strong Santiago Longoria is going to muscle his way for another Rattler first down. And near the 10-yard line, they're going to officially tackle him down at the 13.
Yeah, it's another big-time first down for the Rattlers. Hopefully the Javelinas can put something together here defensively, come away with the stop. Best-case scenario right now, or worst-case scenario, well, maybe it's best-case scenario, right? We stop them to a field goal.
Well, we got movement. Yes, yeah, you're absolutely right. You got to hold them to a field goal. This is going to help. This is going to be a penalty.
Full start. Offense. 5 yards. First down.
I mean, best-case scenario, right, would be a turnover, but those, yes, let's be realistic. They're tough to get, right?
Yes. Well, so, I mean, there's been two in the ballgame.
Right.
And they've both been forced by the Javelina, so.
Can they get the hat trick? This would be a great time for it.
That would be huge. That would be huge. And that may be the saving play. Carrell lofts it. Great touch.
Oh.
Wow. What a grab. Eduardo Mendoza all night long. He's been close to making a spectacular catch. And there we saw it, folks. What a beautiful touch pass. My goodness. That's a big time football. First and goal for the Rattlers. They're knocking on the door. A direct give to the running back, and that'll be an easy touchdown for Santiago Longoria. Wow, the Rattlers storm back and retake the lead, 18-14.
Yeah, it was a good play there. Here we see on the replay, man, he just throws it on a dime. What a great diving catch. Look at that catch. Wow. As he's going to the turf.
Just that's special. I tell you what, great camera coverage once again.
Absolutely.
That's perfection right there. My, I tell you what, Isaac, I'm hoping you get a treat here because it's awesome being
and
up in the
booth,
man.
It's like you said,
watching
man.
These kids play.
It was 6-0, and you said it was going to be some scoring. And there we see Bo Krill get into the end zone for the 2-point conversion. So that's going to force the Javelinas to kind of have to score on this drive. And then, of course, they have to make that extra point.
Well, we got 6:35 remaining. The issue is still in doubt, but, you know, Sherryland High now takes the lead over PG Southwest 20-14. And, again, one thing we got to emphasize, Southwest is about to get the ball back, but they only got two timeouts. So, in all essence, this is pretty much the drive.
You need
to come away with at least a field goal to cut it in half, preferably a touchdown, Sherryland. They get a stop. They get a couple first downs. Southwest will exhaust their final two timeouts, and they're going to go into victory formation.
You know, if only it'd be that easy, right?
Yeah, well,
but,
it's like I always say, I'm undefeated up here at the booth. I've never lost a game. So easier said than done. So we're going to see.
Yeah, six and a half minutes.
Javelinas respond. And that's a key. You know, right there, we talked about it earlier. What can you take to the offseason? And if you're a proud Southwest football supporter, what you want is a comeback and say, we came out on a positive note. We fought tooth and nail against a good program. We beat them to end the season. Let's work our butts off, and let's have a successful season next year.
Absolutely. And, you know, this is kind of, as we see, it's going to be fielded right there. So they're going to get some good field position right here. He's still on his feet.
Uh-oh, little bump at the end. No flags, though.
Letting him play. All right.
So the Javelinas will have good solid field position, as you mentioned, just past the 30 at about the 32-yard line.
And you know, we were kind of talking about it earlier, Javi. You know, this is where this is the time is now, right?
Yes.
If you were ever going to have a five-minute drive, it needs to be here. But you got to come away with points.
Yes, most definitely. You know, we got 6.5 minutes, 6:28 to be exact.
And, I mean, you know, fair point. If you're going to take 5 minutes off the clock, you got to come away with a touchdown.
You might as well. You might as well get a touchdown.
Yeah.
And I think that's the end of the day right there. The bottom line is you got to come away with a touchdown here. I don't think you settle for a field goal.
Right.
And on first down, though, the Rattlers have other thoughts as they make a tackle in the backfield. So, loss of one. So, 2nd and 11 upcoming.
Yeah, another big-time drive right here for the Javelinas. There we see Marcus Loengles. He's getting that play in right now.
Yeah, that was the 9th tackle for a loss for the Rattlers this evening. The quarterback under pressure. He's got to have to hurry, and he will not get out of the grasp of Santiago Longoria, who just scored a touchdown. Now he picks up a quarterback sack coming from the blind side.
Yeah, that was a big-time play there by Longoria. I mean, it pushes The Javelinas all the way back to the 24. Could have been a horse call. It was very,
yeah,
very close.
Yeah, it was very close, yes. And again, the closing speed by Longoria Luengo, just never saw him. Couldn't get rid of the ball. And quickly, you know, it's third, as you mentioned, very, very long. Third and 22. They're going to air it out. And incomplete. So they gave it a chance. They allowed the Caleb Salas to use the speed, try to get downfield, make a grab for a first down. Instead, it's going to be a quick three and out.
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much the only play that you're really able to do, right? It was third and a mile, third and 22. The only chance you got is really going to be a deep route. You know, unfortunately, it's incomplete. Javelinas are going to have to punt this one away, and they've got to get a quick stop here in order for them to still have a chance. Still again, a lot of time. It can be done.
Right, right. It's 5:03, and the other thing that, you know, it depends on which way you're looking at it, but, of course, we're supporting our hometown, you know, Southwest Javelinas. The clock stops with the first down, so that may help them with only two timeouts remaining. But, first of all, they got to contain this punt and punt return, and they do a good job, but the Rattlers are going to have tremendous field position right at the midfield line, right at the 50-yard line. So,
yeah, they're setting up, I mean, directly right in front of us. I think we have the best view in the entire stadium.
Oh, yeah. Well, here we go.
Yeah, let's see if the defense can come
up with a stop. The field. You know, I wouldn't be shocked if they just go over the top right here just to say, you know what, everybody's expecting the run, and they're going to run it. And the Javelinas were looking for it, but except Longoria breaks a couple of tackles right at the line of scrimmage, falls forward for about 3 yards up to the Javelinas' 47-yard line.
Yeah, Longoria's been a tough one that the Javelinas have had trouble bringing him to the ground, man. He's been pounding his legs, keeping his feet moving, everything that you ask and expect of your running back to do. He's been doing it tonight.
Well, Santiago Longoria has 15 carries on the evening for 113 yards, leading all ball carriers in that department. And, of course, the Rattlers are going to take their sweet time now, milk the play clock, and more importantly, the game clock. They're going to get set with about 10 seconds remaining on the play clock. They're going to try to draw them off sides, get a free play. Instead, they're going to run it up the middle again. Longoria, the workhorse.
Oh, he almost
bobbled it. But I think the whistles had blown forward. Momentum had stopped. Longoria gets past the 45 to the 44-yard line of the Javelinas. And, you know, we quickly glance, and they receive Longoria's run. And here's where you see the ball coming out. And, my, if that would have been
I think it
would have
stood as a fumble if they were able to get it out.
And now the issue becomes the clock. We're at the 3.5-minute mark.
Oh, that's an illegal snap. They got
Okay, there you
see, they even got me saying
they heard you.
Snap.
They heard you. They heard you. Of course, we have the window open, so.
Illegal snap. Offense, number 60. 5 yards, still third down.
Big call right there. Big infraction by that center.
Huge. It's unfortunate. You know, it's one of those situations they're trying to use their cadence to get them offsides.
Yes.
And it's just one of those situations where, you know, there are times where it backfires.
And that time it did. So it'll be 3rd and 9. So this is where the Javelina defense has their opportunity. And, of course, they're going to have to face a very good passing quarterback in Bo Krill, who's going to air it out here on 3rd down. He's got a man wide open, and it sails through his hands. Perhaps a little bit too much mustard on it. Perhaps a little bit too tall. Intended receiver Mario Mendoza could not come away with the reception. And, again, two things to note on that. It's an incomplete pass, so it brings up a 4th down,
and
it stops
the
clock. So the Javelinas retain their 2 timeouts. They didn't have to call a timeout here.
Yeah, great job defensively by the Javelinas. There wasn't a whole lot, right? Krill had to get rid of it quickly.
Yeah, and I simply think that Mendoza right there.
Oh, Javi, look, it's over
it's
his head.
It's a bad snap, and here we
What's
go.
What's he going to do?
They're going to tackle
him. They got
him.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, wow. Just what the doctor ordered, a bad snap. You had a snap infraction and then a bad snap. And the punter almost punted
it.
He tried to.
If he had, I think that ball's going in
wow,
the stands.
Look at that. I mean, that's way over his head. And he picks it up.
Man.
And
he tried to do it right there, but then he saw that guy.
And finally,
it's just,
they're able to corral him. And the Javalinas miraculously
have the ball ordered
at the 21-yard line. I tell you what, that's what I'm saying. I think crazy things happen week in and week out here at PGA Stadium. You got to love it here. Well, they need a touchdown, simply put. Rolling out, and
PA
staying on his feet, bumped out of bounds. And I tell you what, they're bumping him out of bounds past the white, and
it's getting close.
It's getting close. It's getting very chippy out there. So up to the 17-yard line, gain of 4.
And he stops the clock by going out of bounds.
That's a smart decision right there. So Javalina still have those two timeouts in their back pocket. It's 2nd and 7. Officially, from the 18-yard line of the Rattlers, misdirection.
Lots of running room. Can he pick up those valuable blocks?
And he does. They're going to say he stayed in bounds. I thought he was tackled out of bounds, but instead it'll be at the 11-yard line. Great play call. Great blocking. Great execution.
Yeah, the clock does stay running, but you know what? That's okay. It's a good situation.
Well, now it's in their favor, exactly.
Yeah, exactly. We got 2.5 minutes. We're inside the 15-yard line, right at the 11.
I'll take that one. Of course, you know, it's 1st and 10 from the 11. Now you got to think Sherryland might want to call a timeout.
Absolutely. Make them force them to waste theirs. They still have all three.
So the chess match continues, and on 1st down, going nowhere quickly is the running game of the Javalinas. Lopez tried to get around the edge, could not.
Yeah, there really wasn't much room for him to get anywhere. Looks like he, you know, might have gotten barely back to the line of scrimmage, so we'll take that as well.
Well, we're at the 2-minute warning here. Under 2 minutes to go. Javalinas, they've got 3 plays to pick up a 1st down. 12 yards gets him into the end zone. There's a pass, and there's a man, and
oh,
it goes right through his hands. Maybe a bit too tall, but we do have a penalty. And is this a hold? And I believe it is. And now decision time. Do you put him in 3rd and 10 or 2nd and 20? I'd put him at 2nd and 20.
And it looks like they're going to decline.
Holding. Offense. Oh. Number 64. 10 yards.
Yeah, okay.
Replay 2nd down.
Yeah, that's a wise thing to do. Move him back. And, you know, a great pass, almost an incredible catch right there by Ozzie Espinosa. It wouldn't have counted either way
right,
due to a hold call, but I'd go back to a very similar pass like that. Something up the, you know, on a skinny post right there in between the hash marks. Something quick. So it'll be 2nd and 25, but they need 26 to get in the end zone. They're going to air it out. They got a lot of lead blockers. Quickly getting to the ball here are the Rattlers. A big open field tackle right there by number 25, showing off his closing speed, Vladimir Trevino.
Yeah.
And, of course, the ball carrier gets tackled in bounds. It's 3rd down. And this, I think the Javalinas need to call a timeout here to regroup.
Regroup, yeah. This is definitely 2-down territory, right? It's 3rd and 16. Get them together. That's kind of why, you know, the Rattlers were wanting to call, or not wanting to call, but to push them
further
back, because regardless, it was going to be four down territory.
Yes, correct. So now they got to manufacture 16 yards to get a 1st down. 17 gets them into the end zone. Quarterback rolls out to his right. He's got to get rid of it. He's going to tuck it. He's going to run. Can he get past the defender? He does not. He gets tackled at the 12-yard line. Gain of 6, but definitely brings up a 4th down. Javalina still yet to call a timeout.
Yeah, I'm assuming they're going to call it soon.
Finally call it with 39 seconds.
Timeout. PSJ Southwest.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, folks, the drama continues here at PSJA Stadium. You know, KTRI bringing you another fantastic finish. And, of course, this is a District 16 5A Division II matchup, PSJ Southwest, Sherryland. And right now, Sherryland holding on for dear life, and PSJ Southwest you know, they're close. They're knocking at the door. They're only 12 yards away from the end zone. A touchdown would win it. Well, the extra point would win it. Touchdown would tie it.
Yeah, and it's one of those situations where it's they're at the 12, but it's fourth and goal.
Yes.
There's no more chances or opportunities to pick mm-hmm. up a first down. Mm-hmm. It's touchdown or bust on this play for the Javelinas.
Biggest play of the ball game upcoming. Shotgun formation in the pistol, man in motion. Javelina snap it. They're going to fake it. They're going to try to pass it, and the quarterback in heavy pressure. He's got to throw it to somebody. He throws it in the back of the end zone. A lot of bump and touchdown, Javelinas. Yes, sir. Wow, what a fantastic.
Wow. Pass.
I said you got to throw it, and he threw it. And then the grab is made in the back of the end zone. Now we got to. Now this hurts. We've got a penalty on the Javelinas for excessive celebration. What would
sideline
be?
Sideline warning.
Oh, they PSA dodged a huge bullet.
First play was a touchdown.
Wow, they dodged an incredible bullet on that one. I thought they were going to flag him. So here we see.
Wow, great job. It's almost like if he heard you, get rid of it. He said, no, not yet. Now I'm going to do it. What a great play.
A wing and a prayer. One-handed grab off the helmet.
Javi, that's an NFL touchdown.
In play. That's got to be a highlight reel on ESPN, Fox Sports. I'm sending it to everybody.
Timeout.
Wow.
Houston Southwest, their final timeout of regulation.
The circumstances, everything that was
goodness.
On the line, right?
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
You know, everything that was on the line on that play, it's fourth down. They couldn't get a first down. It had to be a touchdown. Javi, that's a touchdown in the NFL. He got both feet.
On fourth and 11 from the 12.
I mean,
desperation pass.
He had
pass.
To have been a 16th away from
and
that white line.
And I tell you what, he threw it on a line. That had zip
yeah.
on it, and he one-handed,
wow.
left-handed. You know, most of us are right-handed. He grabs it with his left. Gets the aid of his helmet. At the same time, he knows he's at the back of the end zone. Stays in bounds. Now the most important extra point ever coming from this young man. It's got to be a good hold. It's got to be a good snap. And let's see if Sherrilan ices him here.
That's
we
good.
We got a penalty flag. Time
offsides.
Out. We got a penalty flag. The incomplete, it was no good. But were they offsides?
Offsides?
They got there really quickly.
Well, personal foul for leaping on the defense.
Yep.
Half a distance and retry.
You know what? I go for it here. No, I do not. I want to get the extra point.
You know, it's been
Let's
tough,
get
right?
The point. Let's get out of Dodge with a victory. And as I said, Lady Luck. All of a sudden, midway through the third quarter, sat
a timeout. Sherrilan High. First timeout of the second half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, as I was starting to say, I want to say about 8 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Lady Luck somehow found the Southwest side. You know, they where she sat, behind the bench, in the stands, but she was there, and Southwest magically made some plays.
And here we got the replay again.
Wow,
I mean,
what a play.
Luengo just kept his poise the entire time, literally waiting to the final second. Javi, look at his feet.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Good
My goodness.
Lord.
And he held on to it. Touchdown, and now we're anticipating the extra point. Well, it's going to be a little shorter. I don't know if that affects you. Good snap. Good hold. The kick is up.
That's good.
And this time it is good as we hear the roar of the crowd. And then we see the celebration in the crowd. PSJA Southwest has stormed back on their final drive. A five-minute drive. A four-and-a-half-minute drive, as you mentioned. 21-20. PSJA Southwest over Sherrilan High. They came in clutch. And I'll tell you what, I got to give a shout-out to one of my buddies, Eduardo Tafich, who always comes in clutch for me, bring me supplies, but the extra point is good.
Right down the middle. Definitely
wow,
no question
coverage.
There.
the agony of defeat, possibly for Sherryland, and the thrill of victory. And there we see the big bad Javelina dancing.
He's excited.
Stands.
We're all excited, man. The suspense has been killing me the entire time. Javi, you nailed it on the head, man. I mean, we went into halftime 6-0.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
The score right now is 21-20 with 29 seconds left. It's been a heck of a second half.
Beautiful, brilliant second half. Both teams came out firing, throwing fists, throwing knockout punches. And right now, you got to think about it. We got 29 seconds remaining. The Rattlers have a quarterback with a cannon of an arm. They've got speedy receivers. Let's see what happens. And they've got two timeouts. It's not over yet, folks.
It's definitely
not. Over yet. The kickoff fielded at the 10. Brought back quickly and corralled, and that might even help the Javelinas as the return man gets bumped around viciously, stays on his feet.
Yeah, that
clock
return.
Now at 23 seconds.
That return knocked off about 6 seconds.
Yes.
There we see he makes it. There wasn't really a whole lot for him to good. That was great kick coverage there by the Javelinas. Let's see what happens. They got to be able to avoid the big play, right? You don't. It's definitely a situation where you can bend, but you cannot break.
Well, we can see right away right here. They're going to send for three men deep to play center field. And that's a key. Do not allow a receiver to get behind
exactly.
you. Exactly. Do not allow him to get behind you. So we're going to see. Give up the underneath routes. Make a sure tackle. Krell looking. Fires. Pass is caught at around the 40-yard line. That's going to move the chains. 16-yard pickup on the first pass and catch. So they're going to officially say the 41, 17-yard pickup for Krell. Krell well over 200 yards passing on the evening, 236 to be exact.
And it's a heads-up play by Harris, being able to make the catch and get out of bounds.
So Krell once again, and wisely the receiver after the reception gets out of bounds. Smart move right there. Savvy move by Eduardo Mendoza.
Timeout for injury.
So it's an injury timeout. That's going to stop the clock with 12 seconds. So it's a long way to go. You know,
right.
You got to cross midfield first of all. And now the other thing you got to think about, they don't need a touchdown.
They don't. And that's why we keep saying they can't really break, right?
Right.
If they can keep them, I mean, what, they'd probably need, right now they're at the 47?
47, yes. I say they got to get at least to the 30. So you're talking
about
23 yards.
Yeah.
23 yards minimal in 12 seconds and have an opportunity to get the field goal unit out. And, of course, they got two timeouts to work with. And, of course, every first down, the clock will stop momentarily. It'll pause for the chain gang. There we see a round of applause as the Southwest player is walking off the field. So that's always a great sign. And Aiden Vela, of course, the punter, he's played tremendously well this evening. Not just with the punting duties, but he's made some good plays defensively. So here we go, folks. High drama here at PGA Stadium. 12 seconds remaining. Javelinas clinging to a 21-20 lead. What a way to end the Thursday night schedule.
Absolutely.
Krell is going to throw it. Is that a fumble?
Well,
he's in the pocket, so that's going to be intentional grounding.
Right,
that's
what the coaches are clamming for over here, right?
If it is.
I don't know that he was outside of the tackle pocket because the tackle box, the ball was at the hash mark, and that's where he stayed.
But it didn't get back to the line of scrimmage.
It didn't, and I didn't see a receiver in sight either.
No. And the NFL, it's a runoff as well. I don't know in high school football. It'll definitely be a sack if it is intentional grounding.
Intentional grounding.
Yeah.
Offense, number 13. That foul comes with a 10-second subtraction.
There it is.
Ball game.
Wow, look at that. I want to see the jubilation right there.
Correction. That is
beautiful.
Correction.
Uh-oh. Okay, what do we have?
We might have peaked a little too early on.
Sherryland has elected to take a timeout to negate the runoff.
Okay. I was about to say, there's
It'll
be a loss of down at the spot, third down.
I was about to say, there's one clause in there that they, and I was hoping it slipped by, but you can avoid the runoff
by
if
using
you
your
have a timeout.
Yes, and they have two of them.
Yes.
And so now they're down to one, but they still, you know, 7 seconds left. So that changes.
This,
yeah, that's
this
it,
is
man.
It.
Now you got to go downfield.
This is it.
You know, watch out for your hook and ladder. Watch out for your, you know, just all
these
throwbacks.
And I always joke around, this is a good time to run the triple reverse pass.
There we go.
They'll never see it coming. Tight end, you know, left tackle eligible.
There we go.
And he's just running down the field. Hey, I can't catch it. And he catches it and he gets caught at one. Well, ball game over. He didn't get in.
Over.
But, you know, all joking aside, this has been an incredible football game.
Absolutely.
And, you know, and this is why you play the game. This is why you play the game, Isaac. You know, both teams come in on paper 0-4 in district. Say, well, you know, it's going to be mushy game, not too exciting. Next thing you know, we may have seen possibly the play of the year.
Absolutely.
On that touchdown
I don't
pass.
Even think I can't argue with that. That was an absolutely amazing catch. Carlos Luna on fourth down. Fourth and goal from their 12.
Well, this is it. The Rattlers. Last gasp. Krill, he's going to show up his arm. He's going to throw it. He gets hit as he throws it. And
that's it.
That's it, folks. Pass is incomplete. The Javalinas are joyful once again. They're getting showered with water. I tell you what, they deserve to celebrate.
Absolutely.
As if they just won the national title or the Super Bowl.
And
they
not only
deserve
that,
this,
you know,
evening.
You've got to be happy for those seniors, right?
Yes.
I mean, what a way for them to be able to end their senior season. Clearly not going the direction that they wanted it to, but to be able to end it with a win and in a fashion that they won, wow.
Great evening. And again, it was pack the house night. So all the youngsters, all the future Javalinas showed what Javalina pride is all about. I'm happy for this program. I think Coach Leha, you know, it's the first year.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be tough.
You got your bumps,
it's a
your
program
bruises.
That, you know, hasn't excelled that often. Only one time in the playoffs in school history. I think this is the right man. I think tonight shows they could have just folded. They were down 12-0.
Absolutely.
But they said, you know what? We want to get a win. We want that big J to be flying high, and the Javalinas prevailed this evening.
Yeah, the future definitely looks bright for PSJ Southwest, and it's a good, exciting thing to see where this program is going to be headed.
Well, congratulations to the Javalinas, and good luck. Safe travels to the Rattlers tomorrow. We got a big one, PSJ High, Edinburgh High, championship game. Any last words, Isaac? It's been a pleasure, buddy.
Javi,
I tell you what,
I mean,
man.
It was awesome to be back, man. It was an absolute pleasure seeing the crew again, the guys that do such a fantastic job. It was great to be a part of it again for one night. It was just great to be back. Anytime you guys want to have me back, I'll always come back.
Well, definitely keep you in mind and with a short leash because you live right down the road.
There we go.
On behalf of Isaac, Izzy, I'm Javi Martinez. I hope you enjoyed the game. Good night, God bless, and safe travels.
And what a great fourth quarter. Congratulations to the Javalina Nation for ending the year on a high note. We want to remind you tomorrow here at PSJ Stadium, the PSJ Bears are going to be hosting the Edinburgh Bobcats for the district championship. So stay tuned. Games tomorrow starts at 7 o'clock. That's all we have tonight. You all have a great night. Drive safe and see you all tomorrow.